Anything working toward the goal is social. So.
Like, did Susan attach your camera to a dog?
Susan, I'm getting nauseous. I'm going to shut your video. What are you doing?
You guys are so funny. Hold on, I'm trying to get this. I'm in a hotel room. I've only been here a couple hours, so hold on now.
Have they turned the gravity off? You like in Project Hail Mary in between when they do the centrifugal rotation?
Check it out. Look at my place. There's a kitchen. It's like what Adrian had the other day. Kitchen, there's a sitting room. There's a huge bathroom. And here's the bedroom back in here. Look at, I got a nice view.
Wow.
Where are you?
Denver.
Ooh, you
a really nice place. I didn't know I got a suite. This is our second. I had a suite in Buffalo too. I was like,
oh, sweet. Sweet.
It's got a kitchen, so I went to the store and bought a whole bunch of groceries.
What the hell is that next to the microwave that's kind of designed like a microwave with the hinges? The same kind of that's a cabinet. That's a cabinet?
Yeah, they just flip up.
Like some IKEA prefab.
How do I get this stupid Zoom thing?
Either that or they have three microwaves.
Yeah, that's what I first thought.
They're replicators.
Susan, when you're selecting the video, there's an option to have it be the front-facing camera or the back-facing camera. You can select which one.
Well, I'm trying to just put it on a stand.
Oh, I thought you were trying to. Switch, okay.
No, my laptop doesn't have a. The camera doesn't work, so I'm using an external one, but I have to put it on something to.
If this were a new shakier, we might be able to see Bigfoot.
Yeah.
Let me see if you have that.
Blair Witch.
Hang it from the ceiling by a string and just spin it around.
That works, Susan. Don't touch it.
Except that it's so far away and I'm standing. I'm not sitting. There's people in the waiting room.
I was in there a little bit above average wait time tonight.
This is the table. They don't have normal, like a desk. I'm standing. This is my height. So if I sit on something and I'm going to mute myself. You guys can just talk amongst yourself. I'm just kind of trying to get myself organized.
I was going to say, we were just silent until Susan got here.
Or did I give a game away? Oh, shush.
Oh, speaking of chickens, there's a great episode that came out on Reply All today about a chicken group on Facebook.
Chicken group.
What is Reply All?
It's like birds aren't real, chickens aren't real. What's a chicken group?
No. Not in that interesting direction. No, more of where people would go on Facebook and discuss the foot issue that a lot of chickens develop or general.
If you got
bumblefoot.
Bumblefoot.
That's what it is.
Chickens have all kinds of, and the older they get, one of my real old ones, she walks funny. She's got real stiff legged, and I think her feet hurt. There's nothing obviously wrong with them. Her toes are getting kind of thick and stuff, but she hangs in there.
Good morning. How's everybody?
Good, Jamie.
You're okay. Good.
I have a question for everyone.
Everyone?
Yeah.
Can we put it in the chat? Are we going to go to a room and discuss it in Teams?
No, not that important. Have you gotten your second booster shot, the second COVID booster shot?
I did last week.
Oh, I thought I muted myself. Yeah, I'm done.
Because they haven't been offered in Canada.
Did you get any side effects? More side effects from the second booster than other shots?
No. This is the first time I've had any side effects, and it wasn't horrible, but you know, I could have done without it.
A little bit, but
also I had COVID in January, so it might be almost like this was a third booster shot.
Yeah, because we got our second Moderna booster a couple of days ago, and then God, we were sick. Headache.
Yeah,
nausea,
my coworker had the same issue.
But we had no
suggested and everything.
But we had no, from the first three shots, we had no side effects at all.
Yeah, I was like that. So I didn't have a headache or nausea. I just had chills and like kind of like remember Leonard describing.
How long does it take for symptoms to show with Omicron? Because we were exposed last week.
highly variable, but
it could be as little as a couple of days.
Yeah,
mine was 3 days.
Because I think I'm like in pseudo-inducing symptoms whenever somebody tells me, like the chat start up again, like I tested positive. So it's like any ache or pain or sneeze.
How long was it? How long was it since you got in contact with COVID?
The people we were around was last Friday. And then they informed us yesterday that they had tested positive. So
for me.
So but we're all vaccinated, so there's like no real guarantee that they could have actually been contagious when we were around them or if we'll even get it.
Well, so that's almost a week.
The world here, everywhere I've been, has moved on from COVID. It has been really irritating.
Oh, they're not requiring unvaccinated people at work starting this week to be tested anymore. Mm-hmm. State employees are not required to be tested unless you work in a like healthcare environment.
Yeah, well, that will produce a large increase in the number of cases, and we'll see if they do anything about it. My guess is in most areas they won't.
So here's my question, Susan. Oh, Susan's gone.
Oh.
And Jamie, with regard to your question about symptoms from boosters, it's almost like the reaction of people to vaccinations is variable and depends on a large number of unknown and essentially unknowable items.
Of course, but the first three vaccines, we had no side effects at all. This was just taking a surprise.
Yeah,
congratulations.
I haven't. I think about the same.
Speaking of Jamie's, is Caspian's Jamie ever going to come back?
Yeah, she's just works at in a way that she can't. If she's staying with Caspian, because they don't live together, so if she's staying with him, then she's on trivia. But when she's at home, she doesn't have as good a Wi-Fi and a system set up to be able to handle the, you know, Zoom and everything.
Well, can't she connect telepathically?
Caspian, are you working on that telepathic thing again?
You have to download the latest version of Java to get that.
Okay. So it's mostly, you know, it's, I think Caspian and her talk about the trivia the next day. Every time I see her, we talk about trivia about the when she's missing. But yeah, hopefully she'll come back and visit. But if she's working the next day too, that's another problem.
Mm-hmm. Basically trivia just doesn't fit her current schedule.
Yeah, and it's also internet issues too. So schedule and internet.
I wouldn't be here if I wasn't retired, I'll tell you that.
Yeah, there's a bunch of people who like during lockdown were like coming every week and now we don't see anymore.
Right. We can't really get here as much. Gosh, I'm really dark. I don't know how to turn on the light above.
You're just a dark person, Susan. Your personality is so dark.
Yeah. Well, it's I don't know what buttons to push in here. There's just
just talk to it. See if it just tells. Say turn on the lights.
The
So as I'm about to fly for the first time since this whole thing started 2 years ago, I'm wondering, and now no one has to wear masks or anything, does anyone care of anything? If I start getting sniffles right before the day I get on a plane, do I even bother taking a test or just not worry about it?
It depends. Take the test, but it depends on...
No, don't take the test.
Well, it depends on whether the requirements for the airlines. Do they have any now?
None.
Domestically, there's nothing.
Nothing. I've been on flights every few days. I've had tons of flights and almost nobody's masked, and it's not a problem. Nobody cares. The whole airport, nobody's masked. The workers,
nobody's masked. Oh my god.
I'm flying at the end of the month. I'll be masked.
Well, you'll be one.
Yeah, me too. I'm going to fly into Germany and I'm definitely going to be masked.
Of course. Everyone still wears masks here, traditionally. You don't go outside without a mask, period.
Wow.
And it's not, and there's no law. I think the law was taken back, but I think just culturally, people simply wear masks because they don't want to spread disease, just in case. So just culturally, wears masks outside.
They're nice.
All the time?
Disease.
Jamie, they wear masks all the time, independent of how they feel?
Outside. Now they do, yes, outside. Yes.
No, but you said that they, you said culturally they do.
Hi, Julia. Oh,
traditionally, if someone has a cold or a flu, they wear them.
But only if they don't feel well.
I don't have my glasses on right. So
but now, because of that culture, everyone wears a mask outside. Everybody does. In fact, if you don't, people stare at you.
Oh, wow. Quite the opposite. I went shopping the other day, and I think I was the only person. Well, I would guess of the 300 or so as a guest people in the store, like four other people with a mask on.
What are you doing?
I felt like I was being stared at.
No, I'm just playing with this hammer that I found in my parents'.
Okay. Hey, you guys. Table. Hey, you guys. So Julia's here. Julia, tell people.
Wait, we said hello to Julie, but she can say more.
Hi, Julia.
When did you talk?
Hi, Leonard.
Before you got on. We were not just sitting here quiet before you got on, Susan. We were talking.
We recognize Julia. She history existed
before us, before I got here.
Yeah.
So Rob is sitting in my room at my house. That's my house. The screen he has behind him is my house.
Where are you, Susan?
And the sun's still up.
I'm in Denver.
Cool. You're still there.
Well, I can't take my in the lights out and everything. It's so much cooler than it was in St. Louis. I left St. Louis this morning.
Susan,
I did my vlog in St. Louis last night.
Are you gonna stop at Red Rocks amphitheater?
No, I'm very likely not gonna leave my hotel room until I go to my talk tomorrow, and then I go back to the airport. I'm right next to downtown. Mm. And I walked down there and I had a slice of pizza and I went to the grocery store. It is scary down there. I remember Denver being really nice and everything, and this is not nice.
Where are you in Denver? Denver, when I was
downtown, I'm right smack. I'm a block away from the main downtown. It is dirty. It's lots of graffiti. There's people who are clearly mentally ill or off their meds, or
You're just downtown in Denver, just in the middle of downtown.
I'm in a Hilton. It's a beautiful. Beautiful hotel.
Are you sure you just didn't get a hotel room in like the bad part of Denver?
No, you're right by that 16th Street or whatever. Yeah,
yeah, I'm on 15th Street.
Yeah, it's a little bit more run down than it used to be.
It used to be beautiful. Oh, I've been here a few times, and this has always been a really nice area. And now there's a lot of storefronts closed. There's like a CVS store that's all boarded up with a wood.
Yeah,
somebody's broken in.
Antifa.
It's just awful. It's
pretty trifling.
I've never seen this before.
Yeah, if you'd have stuck around another day, Susan, you could have had 93 degrees and 56% humidity.
And if you switched up the weeks you were here, you could have had no humidity. It's been cool.
Denver's going to be nice. I bought a bunch of groceries, so I don't got to leave. Tomorrow, there's breakfast in the hotel room.
What's the group in Denver you're talking to?
Speaking of travel, is the next cruise that you guys were planning going to happen?
No, we canceled.
Yes, the cruise will happen. No, we won't be on it.
We won't be on it.
Yeah, it was Russia thing kind of helped not make it
Yeah, they might launch one of the hypersonic weapons and you're just getting away.
Well, no, one of the most interesting stops on the cruise was in Russia, and that's not going to happen.
Yeah, so it was an overnight stay in St. Petersburg where it was possible to take the train into Moscow and
you're missing nothing. Have you ever taken that cruise? The
what? Reason why. Missing nothing, like to see the Winter Palace and Jamie, I thought about studying abroad in Moscow for a whole semester.
For a semester, or you were going to study for a semester?
I thought about studying abroad for a whole semester.
Which abroad were you going to study for a semester?
This was back in like 2004.
Faith, what I meant is
pretty interesting.
I don't know if the Oxford comma would help that. sense. But
my wife and I went to Moscow and St. Petersburg years ago, and we loved it, absolutely loved it. But it was during one of the G8 conferences, and the entire city was closed. So the ships that were in port couldn't, all the tourists couldn't get off the ships. So we had a week in St. Petersburg all by ourselves. It was wonderful. When they opened up the ships to allow tourists, the trouble with the cruise boats is that there's like a million tourists. So when you go into the Winter Palaces or the Hermitage, it's so crowded, you can't imagine. So the best way to see Russia is not by a cruise ship, because you have just tons of people. You can't see a thing. That's the problem with taking a cruise to Russia. If you go by yourself, the country is actually wonderful.
But it's almost next to impossible to get a visa to go into Russia. Even before the war, you had the only way you could get into Russia as a U.S. citizen. I don't know about European countries, the particular European countries, but you have to have a visa. The only way you can get around that is if you enter by boat through a cruise ship or a ferry. Yes.
It wasn't a problem. But we got a visa. It took about a month.
How long ago was this, Jamie?
How long ago?
This was 2008, 2009.
Right, so irrelevant.
Yeah. A lot of shit has happened since then. Crimea, yeah.
Yeah, but it took about a month for us to get a visa, and we had to hire a company. You had to be invited by Russia to visit. So we had to hire a company, and you pay a lot of money to hire a company to represent you to get a visa. So it took about a month or two to get a visa. It was tough. It took a lot of money. It took an effort to get a visa.
We had to hire someone. It took a dump truck full of money in a month, but it was real easy.
Yeah.
Yeah. That's how exactly.
That's how it works.
My God.
Yeah, but the cruise ships. Oh my God.
I'm the not cruise ships. So you guys move people. We have a guest. We'd like her to come back again. So you guys all nip it in the bud.
No.
I want that.
They picked on the way I was talking. And I did not appreciate.
Hi, Peggy.
Because I believe in the Oxford comma.
Peggy.
I also believe in the Oxford comma. I'm a big proponent of the Oxford comma.
She's
Oxford commas not only exist, but they are wonderful.
They're necessary.
That's right, Leonard. You said it.
Julia.
Believing in the Oxford comma is not enough.
I'm talking to Julia.
I made a comment on Seth Andrews had a whole thing about
sitting at the end of the table. So I made a not your communication director. He's joined DSOW. He's already on lesson two.
Wow. That's awesome.
That's the only editor I've gotten so far.
From Buffalo? I've had
nothing but positive feedback on everything. They've just, I showed that video that I showed you guys.
Yeah.
I showed that video at St. Louis and it was really good. What are we looking at?
Vampire Weekend.
Oh, sorry,
they have a second. Song called The Oxford comma.
Oh, I just Googled what it means. I like this too.
Yes, that's good.
It's the broadband's too slow.
Yeah. It's who's sharing? It's not working.
Yeah, just turn it off, Avi. This is not getting anything.
Yeah. Oh well.
Yeah, without that comma, it's ambiguous.
Mm-hmm. Here comes Terry.
The worst part is when the list of things has, like, there are commas among the things of, you have a list of things within.
That's when you use the semicolon.
Yep.
Because let's eat grandpa can have two whole total different
exactly.
And then a comma after eat.
Yeah, but that's not an Oxford comma. Right. Commas are important.
A comma that is important.
Yeah, commas are important, but Oxford commas are a specific issue.
Which apparently Oxford University Press doesn't use.
I'm trying to get rid of you.
British English tends to not use it.
That just happened.
In my
experience. What are you doing over there? Why, Susan, or Rob, why are you sharing your screen?
Oh, is that what's happening? I was trying to stop whoever was sharing that video that wasn't working, and I pushed
the button. Was me. But I, you could have just waited for me to stop sharing it. I was about to do that.
That's what happened. Yeah, and I was in some weird mode there. I didn't know I was sharing it, and I had no control over the way it looked, which was weird. Okay, so I'm going to make the breakout rooms. Susan, do you know if anyone else is joining later?
Well, I'm sure there will be.
Oh, no names. Okay. So, all right. And so far, I have. Speak up.
Wendy isn't going to be here tonight. She said she wanted to be, but she's got somebody in town.
Who?
Wendy.
Oh.
So far, as regarding leaving early, I have Avi, Julia, and Terry. Anyone else?
I have to leave in a couple of hours. I have to leave for a few minutes. I have a contractor coming, but I'll come back into the game again. Is that okay?
Yeah, okay, so I won't, you know, I put more people on a team if I know there's a lot of people leaving, and I certainly don't want to put all the people who are leaving on one team, so I'm just trying to get a feel for that. So I won't count you in that. Anybody else? That's it? The three people? Okay, I'm going to make the rooms. Talk amongst yourselves.
Rob, you're going to have to re-add me because I'm on my way home, so I'm going to have to join from my computer once I get there.
Okay.
Thank you. Yeah, that's hilarious, Faith.
Hey, you guys, this tour has been a blast. It has been so much fun. I've met so many people that it's...
Are you getting any sleep, Susan?
Actually, I am, but...
Well, that's good.
I am. I'm getting a lot of sleep now, but boy, the heat really took a toll on me. I'm getting my steps in today. Today, I did 10,000 steps, and I was just at the airport, and then I went and walked up and down the... I went to the airport, and I just walked. All waiting, just walking around. But I got 10,000 steps and just doing.
It was nice to see that you're a real person, Susan.
It was nice to see. And I met Rachel and Jordan. That was great.
Yes.
It was so nice. I got hugs from them.
They had a good time.
Did they draw you?
Jordan showed me some drawings, but no, they didn't draw me. But it was nice. I had a custard.
I'm still the privileged one to be drawn by them.
Chocolate dipped.
Hi, Janine.
Hey, Janine. Janine, sometime this week we should try to see if we can talk because I got some stuff to tell you. Good stuff.
Okay.
Good stuff.
Okay. I have stuff too.
I'll be home in about 3 minutes. I was leaving for leaving a retirement party, so that's why I'm behind.
So you're retiring?
No, someone else that retired. It was their retirement party.
Hey, you guys, my cousin that I've never, ever, ever met showed up at the Skeptics event in St. Louis last night.
That's cool. I mean, was it a good thing or just weird?
Cool. I posted a picture of some place in St. Louis and on my Facebook feed, and she says, oh, that's right around the corner for me. And I said, oh, are you going to my talk? Thinking she was one of the Skeptics. And then I realized a little later she's one of my cousins from the South.
And how did the talk go over with her?
She loved it.
Okay.
Apparently her husband's a police retired police officer. And so we were talking, like I asked him if they've ever had psychics, you know, that are, and he says, nope, I've never had anything. But she was telling me afterwards, she's like, she's had some experiences with some spooky, ghosty things. And I'm like, and I answered, I said, oh, I love ghost stories too. Those are great, aren't they? But then the stuff I showed, the people were just, I started showing in Buffalo and in St. Louis a 15-minute video of Thomas John doing a reading with one of the kids in Operation Onion Ring. And before I do it, I say, hey, you guys, if you want to see this video, you can, but I'm going to take a vote. I'm warning you, it's 15 minutes and it feels like 5 hours. And they all, both places they did, they wanted to see it. And so this time I went in the back of the room and I was just watching the audience react to the thing. And they were just laughing. They just loved it. It was really hard to watch. But seeing them watch it was fun.
Well, it's funny because I had, you know, read some of your articles on Thomas John that I've met, obviously. But you don't, like that voice of his, you don't get that you know, just from reading
his personality. Well, you know, I can't say anything, Julie. I it would just come off as a,
it would sound, yeah, it would sound bad, but
he's awful. He's just, his mannerisms, and like you'll see him, like I said, he'll sometimes he'll be, you know, lotioning up his face and then he's like drinking water. And he's just without saying anything about how horrible it is to watch him, by letting people see the videos, they go, oh my God, you guys, this guy's awful.
Okay, guys, ready? I'm going to open the rooms.
Yes, sir.
Here we go.
I'm not in the room.
Why am I not in the room? Susan, why am I not in the room? Susan's gone. I don't have to worry, Susan is. This is weird. Apparently, it won't put the host in a room, which is me. That's freaking weird. Terry, are you there? Are you there, Terry? Can't hear you. Can't hear you, Terry.
Susan's not hosting it anymore.
Hi.
Nope. Oh. You ain't just in a mood. You are just in a mood tonight.
Hello, Deborah. Deborah looks frozen. What happened to Deborah? What happened to Deborah?
Shoot. She joined a room. I assigned her to a room, and I guess she went to it.
Oh, I was going to do that. Where'd you assign her?
I put her in room one, and I put Karen in room two.
Oh, Karen's here too. Let me see. Breakout rooms.
Those two rooms only had three people each before that.
Okay, I gotta put this on the list. No, but yeah, because room, you got Faith and Romero, just two. One, two, three.
Ben's so, back.
That is four. I don't like that one.
You can put me elsewhere. I have not yet joined, and I won't be able to play for probably half an hour.
Okay, I'm going to put you in room five.
I was all ready and cozy at home and ready to go, and an urgency came up. So I'm driving to a town called Seaside, about half an hour away. Then I have to go right back to my house.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. I'm back in.
Actually, no. I think Carl's was better. Room two. Okay. Sorry. I'm gonna
back to put me in four, please.
Okay. Wait a minute. This is insane that they don't allow you to do this to people who've joined. Let's see. Okay, so you're in room four, right, Ben?
That's what he said.
Yeah, I think so. Avi and Bob. Is that four? I think it was four.
Yes.
Yep.
So I'm a little concerned there because there's only really two people that are going to play the night.
Oh yeah, because I'm still connected with my phone, so I should still show in the room, and then I'll hang up once this gets put into the room.
Let's see.
Yeah, I'm gonna move Karen there. She's not gonna.
Okay, good. Yeah, because once Avi leaves, we'll be down to just the two of us.
Like a tag team, she should be ready by the time Avi leaves.
Karen four.
Yeah, here's one.
Okay, so Jamie, Kyle, Larry, Deborah, Faith, that's four in there. She's leaving. That's four. Okay, that looks reasonable. Okay. Okie dokie. Terry, are you there? I don't think Terry even went to the room. I'm not sure what's going on there. Terry is not answering.
Oh, there. She's got two devices. One of them's in room three.
Oh, she does. Okay. Wait, are they both? Do they both have her name?
Terry and Terry. Yeah.
Oh, that's confusing. Okay. That explains it. So the one that's here. Let me see. I'm going to rename that if I can do that. Rename. I don't. Yes, I have rename. Terry. Cat's iPad is actually Bob Extra. That's better. So Zoom introduced a security threat, and as far as I know, they still haven't done anything with it. And why do I have Ben as not joined? Did Ben say he was there yet? Ben.
I never got a prompt.
Never
to go to a room. Nope.
Oh. Assign. Room 4, right? So, like, I think Ben's old thing is still there, even though he's not connected with it.
Which one is the old one?
Ah, I don't remember whether the one I just sent was Ben Bellinger or Benjamin Bellinger.
All right, now it's gone.
Yeah, it disappeared as soon as he joined the room with the other one. I think we're good there.
Okay. Yeah, so they introduced a security vulnerability. They made a capability called Whiteboard. Mm-hmm. And the default is that anyone in a group setting, not a co-host or not a host, anyone can throw up the whiteboard and write anything they want on it.
Usually pictures of penises.
Yep. So yeah. to display this, because I found it, I was in the RFRX setup meeting right before the big meeting when we'd have 100 people join, and I started doing it. What the fuck is this happening? Yeah, because that's what Zoom did. Nice. So you have to go to your account online to change it. There's no way to default it to off, but you can flip it off here if you know what you're doing. So I changed Susan's to it to deactivate it just for the hell of it.
So are you not going into participating in a room, Rob?
I am.
Okay.
I'm in room 5, but I was fixing out here for the thing. So I actually go back and see if they picked the name yet.
All right.
Are they doing names now or a quiz?
They're doing names.
Okay, yeah, that's what I thought. I would join them and help my team with answers, but I'm almost there at my destination.
No problem.
It's nice to see your mug, Karl. You have a handsome profile.
I knew exactly where Carl's sitting.
Susan has been to the lair.
With the cats hit. Hi, Karen.
I'm vicariously enjoying your adventures.
It's nice because you can do it without being in the heat that I'm in and the humidity. Karen, let me tell you.
Yeah. 90 some degrees.
Or possible COVID.
90 some degrees.
Yep. It is here too.
Awful.
Yeah, it's pretty humid.
You go in the buildings and they over air condition everything. Mm-hmm. Oh my God, it's about 40 degrees inside the buildings.
Yeah, it's not the heat, it's the humidity. It really is an appropriate phrase.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, Buffalo was really a nice relief because I was in Raleigh and that was, it got bad. And then, well, I thought it was bad. Then I went to Buffalo and I was like, oh, this is perfect. And then I went down to St. Louis and the first day was okay, but the next days were just almost unbearable.
If you just did one more day, you could have had 93 degrees and 56% humidity. It would have been great.
Like we've told you, tell everyone how awful our weather is here so they'll stop moving.
Hey, Susan Gerbeck, we have 4 people in our group, and Terry and Julie are probably going to leave early, so that just leaves Leonard and I. which means it's just going to be Leonard, because I'm not.
Of course, that means your team is going to win.
So probably if you get somebody else that's coming in, you might want to think about that.
So I didn't catch that. Terry's leaving early? She wasn't on my list.
Yeah, that's one of the first.
She was one of the first ones to say in the chat.
I had Abby, Julia, and I wasn't.
Yeah, we told you, Rob, she's going to stay for two rounds.
I missed that. Okay, so there's four people leaving early. Yeah.
So send us somebody.
And I still not. I have not joined any rooms, so use me where you will.
You should put those four people all on the same team.
No, you should move them around. Because, no, there better not be music questions.
I'll put the four people who are leaving, put them all on the same team.
But we'll be down to team two as well once Abby leaves. So, but I think we're getting
when everybody else leaves.
Karen.
Well, I mean, with Susan's team, it's going to be down to just Leonard.
Yeah.
So,
hey, well, Karen, you know,
and they'll still win. No,
I'm not sure I can take this pressure.
Leonard counts as three people. Leonard counts as three people.
Absolutely.
Hey, no fat jokes.
Okay.
let's get that.
Oh, we might have to split up Faith and Romero.
Put them in separate rooms.
I tried that last week, and then Rob put us in the same fucking room. Like,
how dare you?
You did that to Susan and Mark too. Like.
Well, we were in separate rooms.
I think being in the same house and in earshot is too much of a danger for over here.
No, it's not. Do you not know us? We're competitive as hell.
They're very competitive.
They also
let us get.
How can he not hear you from the other room?
Let's get the team names. So
the big house.
Team number one, I believe. Correct me if I'm wrong. If I say any of this, but Jamie, Kyle, Larry, and Deborah. What is your team name?
Oh shit.
Oh shit. Okay. Is that an exclamation mark or not?
I got it. Finns join NATO as Bitcoin goes Helsinki.
Okay.
That's great. That's terrific.
I don't know what that second part means, but that's okay. Team number two.
Bitcoin goes to Helsinki. Bitcoin is collapsing. The value of Bitcoin is falling to pieces.
Oh, goes to Helsinki.
Goes to hell.
Faith, Romero, Janine, and Peggy, what have you picked?
Chinese hurricane cannons.
Hurricane cannons. I don't
know what that means either. Is that a reference to something?
I don't know what that means either. But
okay. Oh, come on, you
it's,
guys.
It's a Trump reference.
Yep. You go.
Oh. Trump, who was asking if the Chinese were using hurricane cannons.
Okay.
Oh.
I didn't even hear that one.
To attack us. And can we retaliate?
Wow. Oh my God. Okay. Team number three, which is currently Susan, Julia, Terry, and Leonard. The Oxford Comma Appreciation Society.
I like it.
Nice.
You're the Acknowledgement Society.
And there's no comma in it. Team four, Avi, Ben, Bob, and Karen.
Well, I guess I should change this slightly. It's in the land of Fermilab, then in parentheses, plus Karen.
Oh, what is that?
You have to give it to
because the rest of us are in Illinois right now, which is where Fermilab is.
Okay. plus Karen. Okay. And the final team, which is the team I am on, Rob, Kevin, Caspian, and Terry. What are we?
Wait, we've got Terry.
Well, we are Karl's Crazy Cat Kingdom.
Sorry, you got Terry, yes.
Oh, Karl's Crazy Cat.
Thank you for the correction. I had that wrong. Karl's Crazy. Karl with a K, of course.
Well, good thing you didn't just go with Karl's Crazy Cat. KKKK. And you went with Karl's Crazy Cat Kingdom because one less word would have been very bad.
It should be Karl's Crazy Krispy Kreme Cat Kingdom.
Krispy
Kreme. Oh, don't. Don't mention Krispy Kreme.
Okay, so this is, if I have this right, game 106. Susan started this in the before time. Barely, or I guess it was the post time, but barely. And what was the date, Susan? Do you remember when the first game was?
It was last week.
2020. June. Oh, we waited for June. It seemed like it was earlier than that.
We're almost at 2 years.
Wow. And it's Game 106, Season 2, Episode 49. So it is Finns join NATO as Bitcoin goes Helsinki, the Chinese hurricane cannons versus the Oxford Comma Appreciation Society versus In the Land of Fermilab plus Karen. And finally, Karl's Crazy Cat Kingdom. We shall see who comes up victorious today. Okay, so Karl is doing all five categories. It is the Karl Show number two, the second time Karl's done this. And good luck, everybody. Karl, what is your first category?
Mute.
Okay. The first category, hypothetically, should be easy for a lot of people. Karl's Greatest Hits, Volume 2. Every question here has been asked before.
You did warn everybody. I recall this. You're
Karl, this would be Volume 3.
Not of Karl's Greatest Hits.
Yeah, you've done this two times already.
No.
I'm pretty sure you have.
I'm pretty sure I know what I've done.
I'm pretty sure you've done your greatest hits twice
I've
already.
I've done greatest hits.
Oh, my
hits,
God.
And I've done leftovers with Karl.
All right, muting people. Yeah, muting people.
Leftovers.
Three, two, one.
Here we go. Number one from the category Space Oddities. Who was the second person to travel into space and land on either land or water in their vehicle? Number two, derived from a bonus round of the Federal Reserve Banks, which state is the only state with two Federal Reserve Banks? Number three, a favorite question, fictional companies, what movie or TV show is TPC from? Gonna keep getting asked until someone answers it. Number four, a general state of misery, or Missouri. Located in St. Louis, what is the oldest standing bridge over the Mississippi River, which is also the first bridge across the Mississippi River south of the Missouri River? Number five, from The Other Guys. This actress quit Star Trek Voyager a day and a half into filming the pilot episode and was replaced in the role of Catherine Janeway by Kate Mulgrew. Number six, cats and other feliforms. A group of cats is a clowder. What is another term for a litter of kittens? And this time you don't get a hint. Number seven, fictional science. What TV show or movie are Terrio Cell computers from? Number eight, fictional diseases. What TV show or movie is a brain cloud from? Number nine, scary movies by bad description. Town mayor addresses boating accident and inadvertently sets model for a Republican response to future COVID-19 pandemic. And finally, number 10, the mad musical genius of Weird Al. Name the Weird Al parody of Stand by REM. And there we go.
Any questions, people, for Karl before we go to the rooms?
So are you sure this is only your second time doing
it? I'll go to your rooms.
Yeah, pretty sure.
You're muted. Oh.
We're the only ones that come back. We gave up first or what?
Yep. We gave up.
Harry, why are there two of you?
Okay, because the phone is for the camera, and then I have a Chromebook so that I can keep the questions, because if I just use the phone or Chromebook, I would lose the questions when I went to the breakout room.
Oh, okay.
She's doing what I did for Operation Onion Ring.
Ah.
So one is just for chat.
That's kind of how I knew to do the Operation Onion Ring that way.
Yeah.
Oh, he says, don't worry, this is going to be the hardest round.
Oh, good.
Round of the night? Is that what he said? Round?
Yeah, round.
Its message is gone, so I didn't see it.
I know. Where did it go? Oh, I didn't know you could do that.
It says at the bottom, whenever you get the powers, it says that you can send a message, but it just goes up there for a really quick time. Ooh, it's starting to get dark out here. It's going to be pretty outside my window. And thankfully, I'm one block away from all the ickiness of the city, so it's going to be pretty where I'm at, sort of. But oh, I'm so disappointed in Denver.
That's too bad. My sister used to live there, and she loved it, but that was almost 10 years ago, probably. So
I think this is my fourth visit here. I think fourth or fifth to see the skeptics. And I've never remembered it being like this. I don't know if this is pandemic problems or just neglect and, you know, people's businesses closed up or something, but it's a shame, you know?
Yeah.
Going through trash cans and stuff all over the ground. But there, I did see somebody coming along sweeping up, but there was just one guy. There needed to be a lot of more places. You feel like you really want to hang on to your purse. I got my purse on. I'm like really like keeping with my mind. Keep eye on purse.
Yeah.
So how often do you have these? Are they every week?
We've never missed a Thursday.
Wow.
That's why we got up to 106 or something. And we've done a few Saturdays too. So that's why we have the number we have. But we've even been on Thanksgiving Day. We've done two Thanksgiving days. We've done
that was Christmas Eve.
We've done New Year's Eve. We've done, if it's a holiday. And you know what? I get a good turnout too. It's really fun.
That's great. So you've done it sometimes. It's on Saturday as well.
We have done Saturday afternoons, but not many because just haven't gotten to it yet. But I might do it again. I should, because I know people are constantly asking. And then if you do it early enough on a Saturday, then you can get a lot of Europeans. We used to we've had a few Australians that come to this one. It's a good time for Australia. I guess everybody was complaining about it being difficult. That's why he said this is the hardest of all of them.
I mean, it was really hard.
I felt
really stupid.
I can see my house. That's so nice to see my house.
It's nice of him to see a
cat jump up or something. If
one of your cats jumps up,
I'm gonna freak out because your cat shouldn't be in my house. You're muted, Rob.
Where is Karl?
Oh, look, Leonard's in my house too. It's daytime too.
Leonard.
Yeah, the light's coming in.
Yeah, it's daytime. It's funny.
These people are so funny.
Yeah, and the direction of the light in the background is the same as the direction of light on my face. So it looks almost real. It's backwards for Rob.
Yeah. Those flowers, yeah, those freesias that I picked out of the garden too.
I'm Mark pretty says equally
he, Mark dark said he picked a head of lettuce.
No, today. there's a distinctly brighter side on you.
Maybe it's just your hair, Rob.
That's because I have a mirror on the side entry to the light from the window so back on my face. That's right.
That was nighttime, Kevin. Mm. That was at night. These are weird.
Hey, Mark.
Where I am.
You guys are so funny.
Mark's not even answering. It's like Mark's frozen or something. He's not even like there.
Look at his eyes.
Well, once you do, you can't stop. They're hypnotic.
Richard just texted me. He says, is trivia on tonight? Yeah, like, why wouldn't it be?
Yeah, we've never. Well, because it's Friday over there.
Well, it's always Friday over there when we play.
Oh.
Not different. What is he talking about? Why is he?
Well, it's because Susan's not in Susan's room like we are.
My family, Caspian and Sterling and, well, Sterling and Mark have both told me, I have no idea where you are now.
My eyes. Look into my eyes.
Caspian, how come we can't see you?
He's muted, so he can't tell us. How come we can't see you, Caspian?
Or hear you?
Because I'm desperately trying to preserve bandwidth.
Why?
Because it's precious. I have a lot of stuff being downloaded all at once.
Uh-oh. He's torrenting stuff again.
No, it's a torrent of information. Oh, that's lovely, Kevin.
All right, Karl just pushed Karl's back. Karl just pushed the close the rooms button. Okay.
Yes, it is.
I guess everybody has problems with this.
Oh, yeah. Like I said, this is by far the hardest round of the night, though hypothetically it should be the easiest for most of you.
I know, but you picked the hardest question.
It depends on what you mean by
hypothetically. And we didn't know him back then either.
It depends on what your assumptions are when constructing that hypothetical. And they seem to be contrary to human nature.
It's interesting to listen and hear some of the exact same discussions I heard the last time on these questions, and people coming up with the exact same wrong reasoning for the exact same wrong answers.
This should not surprise a skeptic.
We're consistent.
Those pathways are well traveled.
Yep, peoples is peoples.
Depp, are we going to go have pizza whenever I get back? You didn't go to the Monterey County Skeptics, did you?
No.
They're going to disown us.
I know, I have a really bad feeling. Case positivity was over 4. I wasn't going to go.
Was it really that?
And it's going up, too.
And I'm going to Florida, where they didn't wear masks in the middle of Delta.
It's true.
You're not taking Delta Airlines, are you?
New airline.
Oh, actually, I took a lot of Delta, and I didn't even dawn on me. Oh, like six of my three or four of my flights.
Delta didn't dawn on you?
Delta dawn.
Delta dawn.
Delta didn't dawn on me. Oh.
Did you drink any Corona while you were on the Delta?
No, I haven't had any Corona the whole trip.
Where are you today, Susan?
I'm in Denver. I just got here a few hours ago.
That's what I thought you said. Are you giving a talk in Denver?
Tomorrow, Friday the 13th. And then I can come on Saturday.
Who's it for?
Colorado Skeptics.
Okay.
It's a new group. I mean, they've been on Facebook for a long time, but I don't think they've ever had a talk.
Oh, are you the first?
I think so. I mean, the Colorado Skeptics used to be big.
Yes.
But that was a powerhouse, but then all the drama happened. And
it was the Rocky Mountain Skeptics.
What drama?
Drama's all done. Don't even worry about it. Just pass.
Are the people still there?
Hmm?
Are the drama people still there?
No, I have a feeling that it's all brand new people. I have a feeling that all the people, I really would be surprised if anybody showed up. Maybe Linda Rosa might show up. But I don't think anybody else is going to show up. That I would be shocked if anybody.
Johnny Depp and Amber Heard.
But they did. They did big stuff.
Well, they'll show up together.
All right.
Give us the bad news.
All right. So number one, none of the Russians in Vostok landed in their vehicles. Only the Americans landed in their vehicles. And Virgil I. Gus Grissom.
Grissom.
Yes.
Really. 1 second.
How many Russians flew?
First, and he was followed by Gus Grissom.
How many Russians flew? By the way, we were talking about that, and it wasn't sure. Before Alan Shepard, was it just one?
I think it was just one. Number two. Missouri has Federal Reserve banks in St. Louis and Kansas City. Number three.
Wait, hold on. Sorry. Did we get that one, team?
Yes.
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 No. But of course, Kansas City is in Kansas, so that doesn't count. Mm.
The smaller one is.
Part of it.
Number three. I have a feeling Deborah is going to once again be disappointed with herself. She once again forgot the president's analyst.
Oh no.
Now I remember you saying that.
Damn that it. You remembered that. That's impressive. But way more impressive
that
than
you own the videotape to it.
You do?
No, I'm not saying I watched it very much. And I don't have a videotape player anymore anyway, so I don't know what I'd be doing with it. But yes.
Number four.
Would you like to borrow mine?
Carl, I have a question on number one. Yes. Is the answer Gus or is it Alan?
Virgil I. Gus Grissom. Gus Grissom.
Really?
Because none of the Russians landed in their vehicle. So the first person to go into space and land in their vehicle was Alan Shepard. The second person to go into space and land in their vehicle was Gus Grissom.
Ah. So it wasn't Yuri that was first.
And you have the excuse of you were not here the first time I did that. So you cannot be expected to remember my trick question. Number four, very disappointed in Susan because
he was just
we talked there. About this bridge. Probably for 15 minutes, Susan. This is the bridge that they discovered Caisson's disease, which is now called the Benz. The
I forgot about that.
Thank
I'm
you.
I'm so embarrassed. Ben. I am so embarrassed. EADS. Just fire me now.
Yay, my Missouri memory actually worked.
We're just going to cut your pay in half, Susan.
But you know what? I could tell you a bunch of stories about it. And what about the bins and how they it needed actually 2 hours to go up instead of like 8 minutes.
Well,
I know the story. I just couldn't remember the bridge.
How do you pronounce that, Carl?
Eads? Eads Bridge.
Eads.
Named after the designer. The guy who built it. Number five. You don't have to have spelling correct for Genevieve Bujold.
Ooh, got the last name. Is that good enough?
Who also starred in the movie Anne of a Thousand Days and the movie Coma with Kurt.
We had the first name and they had the last name.
We got.
I knew she was French.
Is that good?
We got both names.
Carl?
Hmm?
We got the last name. I couldn't remember the first name. Is that good enough?
The last name is fine, Bujold.
Thank you.
And we almost spelled it right,
I should be more
too.
Strict since we've had this before, but I'll take it. Since no one's going to do that well in this round.
If you do it again, I still.
And what's the first name?
Genevieve.
Oh, yeah. I knew it was French. Couldn't remember.
The fun name to say. So, number six. The first time I asked this question, I gave you the hint that you might be able to look up this answer in an ebook because it's a Kindle.
Oh.
That's right.
Dang it. And we would have gotten it too for you meddling kids.
We came up with a cuddle.
No, my fault y'all didn't remember it.
A cuddle of kittens.
How about a caboodle?
A snuggle.
Yeah, we guessed a caboodle also.
He said
a caboodle.
I know at least a couple of teams used good logic to figure out number seven was Blake seven.
Yeah.
Good logic.
They go, oh, whatever, it's a science fiction thing we don't know. It's always that obscure show, Carl.
And I should have done that. By this point, I'm just not going to refuse to ever watch it because it's caused me so much grief. The painful
number
memories
eight,
won't allow me to watch it.
Brain Cloud comes from Joe versus the Volcano.
Oh, Blake Seven for that one.
And that was such a bad movie.
And it's a double.
Good job, Karen.
Even in the movie, it's a fake disease.
Carl, you spelled versus wrong.
Okay. We all get a point because he's spelled versus wrong.
No, he's singing to the volcano. There's no chorus, it's just versus.
Yeah. Joe versus and the volcano. Number nine, probably everybody
we got that one, right?
Yay, we got a point. Yay.
I think that's the only point we got.
I think so.
And lastly, for number 10, Spam.
Wrong spam, but it, I like
wrong song.
Definitely wrong spam.
Yeah.
Somebody already done the spam.
Oh, I'm embarrassed. I am
not so too bad. Okay. Let's see. Sharing screen. Sharing screen. Da, 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 da. There we go. Okay. From top to bottom. Finns join NATO as Bitcoin goes to Helsinki. What'd you get?
One.
Let what? Vincent in the room.
What?
Vincent. Or her, I'll let him in.
Here we go. I got it.
Like one, like the number one.
Oh,
the loneliest number.
Ooh.
Yes.
Chinese hurricane cannons.
Four.
We are not in last place.
Ooh, four times.
That might be the high.
Yet.
It could be. The Oxford Comma Appreciation Society.
Five.
Oh.
New first place.
Good job, Leonard.
I see a trend. I see a trend.
Good job, Leonard. Yeah.
Definitely
Leonard.
Not Leonard.
In the land of Fermilab Plus, Karen.
Six.
No.
And Carl's Crazy Cat Kingdom. I believe we got six. Seven. Is that correct, team? Yes? Yes? No?
You're the one who kept score.
All righty. We got a tie for lead.
Separate men from small furry creatures from Alpha Centauri.
I thought we were going to get like two.
If I only would have thought like seven. Again, it burned me, Carl.
All right, Carl, what is round number two all about?
Okay, round two is unknown trivia theme round.
Oh boy.
What? All answers must fit the theme.
Oh, it's a category. Okay, muting everybody. 3, 2, 1.
All right. Number one. This man was the chairman of the Joint Chiefs of Staff during Operation Desert Storm. He later served as Secretary of State for George W. Bush, and he died recently on October 18, 2021. Number two. This is the highest class of international racing for open-wheel single-seat racing cars, sanctioned by the Fédération Internationale de l'Automobile. Abbreviated FIA. Its premier race of the season is the Monaco Grand Prix. Number three. This is one of the issues faced by the titular character in the Judy Blume book, Are You Their God? It's Me, Margaret. And the answer must be the one that fits the theme. Number four. Introduced in 1963, this niche popular diet soda was discontinued in 2020, much to the chagrin of its loyal fans like Angie Matke. Number five. This was the secret U.S. government counterintelligence agency based in Washington, D.C., that Maxwell Smart worked for in the TV show Get Smart. Number six, American rock and roll, country musician, singer, and songwriter, best known for his 1961 number one Billboard hit, Runaway. And I'm about to play a audio clip. I don't know if you want to pause recording for rights preservation purposes. Name that artist. Name that artist. Number seven. British actress, known for her androgynous style, frequently stars in Wes Anderson and Jim Jarmusch movies. She played the White Witch in the 2000 film, The Lion, the Witch, and the Wardrobe, and the Ancient One in the 2016 film, Doctor Strange. Number eight. This is a song by English synth-pop duo Pet Shop Boys. The song's lyrics are concerned with class and the pressures of inner city life, which were inspired partly by T.S. Eliot's poem, The Wasteland. Number nine. Bruce Lee's final film made before his death in 1973. And finally, number 10, what is the theme? If there are no questions, we can send people to the breakout rooms.
Did you open the roll, somebody? Somebody opened the roll.
I did.
Okay. Vincent is not joining our list. I'm going to put him someplace. Let's see.
Okay.
Where do we want Vincent?
Whose room was it that was going to?
Susan and Leonard.
Yeah.
One, two, three. That's room three.
Ooh. Room three. Hey, cool.
Okay. Vincent. Why is Karen unassigned?
Here I am. Why are you unassigned again?
What happened?
Because I got home and I'm on my computer now, not my phone.
What room?
I'm with Ben.
One, two, three, four. You're room four. Okay.
Ben and Avi.
Room four. There you go.
Thank you.
Okay. So, and I have to go to room five. Room five.
Ben, you're muted.
We're trying to tell each other that we're muted while we're muted.
Yeah.
Like I saw you talking, I go, oh, you're muted. And then I go, oh, wait, I'm muted automatically too.
Yeah, I was trying to tell you that you were muted.
Oh, that's so silly.
Yeah. What is this hammer for?
I was put together to be in my closet.
Oh, okay.
So what is what's Dad doing? Is he not going to play tonight, or is he coming later?
He is performing at a concert. He said he's going to probably join start joining on his way home from the concert, which will be in about like maybe 15 minutes at the earliest.
Oh, okay, cool.
So
yeah,
I guess my Uncle Ron is not joining this week.
Would this have been the first time?
This would have been the third time.
Oh, third time. Okay. What's his name?
Ron.
I'm trying to remember.
He's Ron, and then in parentheses, Al's baby brother.
Oh, cool. Oh, yeah. I think I remember him. When was the last time he joined? Was it like
last week, I think.
Last week? Yeah. Okay. Cool.
Yep.
Cool. You're still on mute, Bob, if you were talking to us.
Yeah, I was saying he was on my team last week.
Oh, cool.
Yeah.
It's weird. I guess, is it always set this way that when we come back? Because there's other times where I come back and we're not automatically muted. So
I have not figured it out. Sometimes when I go to one of the different places, I'm muted. Sometimes I'm not. And I don't understand.
Right.
Matter transporter, you know, something screws up when you get
there. Right.
It's not serious.
I forgot. If he would have left the hint, I totally would have gotten Kindle. Oh well. And I'm sorry, guys. I got burned yet again on that damn Blake 7. Like Karl and I have very similar tastes. Most of what he's watched, I've watched, except for Blake 7, and yeah, it's come up in numerous trivia rounds. And I keep going, like, I gotta watch it one of these days. But now I almost want to not watch it because it's burned me so many times. I'm like, no, I'm not gonna do it. Should I just mark everything as correct? Since we're pretty sure we got. I don't want to be preemptive though, and jinx.
Also, we have Terry's extra account is here, so we shouldn't say anything.
She might be able to hear. Yeah, but we can talk about the previous round. That really bugged. I should have. Why didn't I think of that it was Blake 7? I'm like, damn it. Because anytime I don't know the answer to a sci-fi-ish question, it's always Blake 7.
I have no recollection of him ever mentioning this.
Oh, he's talked about. And what's funny is I've known him for years, and he's talked about Blake 7 multiple times in my presence. So you'd think I'd finally get the hint. But no. In fact, I think we've even had a discussion. Like I've talked to Karl about how, all right, the next time something comes up that I don't know, that sci-fi that I don't know the answer to, I need to answer Blake 7. And I still didn't do it this time. It's just never on the forefront of my mind because I haven't watched it.
That's what blew my mind. You didn't even remember your
own. I know. Curse you, Karl. You're on my list. You're on my shit list today.
Well,
what's sad is it came up before too. So, oh well, you live and you learn.
Well, we still tied for first in the last round.
Yeah,
so
we did all right. But we could have been in the lead if I just would have remembered Blake 7.
Good category. I like the surprise ones, like mystery ones.
Yeah, this was fun. This was a fun round.
Like everyone needed the fun round after round one.
Yes, yeah. I appreciate
it. And as we all know, that the theme for this round was piano keys.
How many?
Well, somebody's not going to get a 10.
How many are there, Avi?
I think there's 88, but I'm not entirely sure.
That is correct.
My dad is a piano tuner, so I should know.
Oh, he tunes them too. Cool.
Yeah. But he doesn't play piano. He just tunes them.
Tunes them. There you go. He's got the ear for it, in other words.
He has to at least play individual notes to be able to tune it.
Yes, I mean anyone can do that. He does have a little ditty that he always. He does have a little ditty that he plays at the end of each time whenever he's done tuning piano. Can he test out all the keys? Mm-hmm. Like he has a customers who call it the "It's time for me to write a check" song.
Uh huh. Nice. That's funny.
Ooh. It should be dun 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 dun.
Yeah, but that doesn't test on all the keys.
Oh, okay. Yeah, yeah, I get you.
So it's nothing as complex as testing out a new organ by playing Toccata and Fugue in D minor.
No. Two
bits. And it's definitely not the Entertainer because that sure doesn't use all the keys.
Nope.
That's one of the few things I know how to play on the keyboard, and not the whole thing, mind you.
Yeah, it's mostly just a bunch of like scales and chords and different things, but just made it in a nice, sweet, simple melody, and I like it.
So everyone back?
Yes, they are, Carl. Give us the good news.
All right.
Everyone gets
a 10. A lot of nines and tens, I expect. Number one was Colin Powell.
Yay!
Number two was Formula One or F1.
All right.
Yay!
Number three, getting her first period.
Oh, so wow. Period, it's like period is beginning, yeah.
Not her first time using a period?
Tab soda.
Oh, no.
It was Deb.
Somebody didn't get the theme if they didn't get that
Yeah, somebody
one.
Didn't get the theme if they didn't get tab soda. Number five, Control.
Oh, we got that right.
Number six. I know at least one more team other than just Kevin got Del Shannon.
Del Shannon, that's yep.
Oh, yeah. Now seven. I will not accept Swenson because it's Tilda Swinton.
Yep.
Not Swenson.
Uh oh. Did we have the last name team?
I had the last name wrong.
I even spelled it right.
I'll be flexible on the name Tilda versus Tildy, but Swinton, it's gotta be Swinton.
We got Tilda. Shit.
We got Tilda.
We had Swinton. Yeah.
Oh, I spelled it correctly.
It spelled right, but it just can't be Swenson.
Well, I can write it down.
So right. Caspian and
I said Kevin. Swinton. We didn't write down Swinton specifically.
That's right. They said it, but I don't like
one thing. That's okay. Probably good.
That's good enough for me.
Thank you.
Eight, West End Girls.
Thank you, Karen.
You got that wrong. West End
Boys.
Is that G-U-R-L-S? No, that's the Katy Perry song.
G-U-R-L-S.
Number nine is Enter the Dragon.
Oh, shoot.
And for anyone who still doesn't have the theme of keys on a computer keyboard.
For nine, can we call it Return of the Dragon? Can we call it Return of the Dragon?
No, that's that doesn't count.
It also doesn't have enter in it. So.
Tab, control, del, tilde, end, enter, keys on the keyboard.
As soon as somebody said the theme in my group, then it was like I got the answer to that. It was like Enter the Dragon.
It was great watching like Rob's group once they got the theme just crank through all the answers immediately after getting the theme.
Definitely helped.
Yeah.
Okay,
that's the thought process. I like to do
let's see if Carl, according to Wikipedia.
Yeah.
That wasn't his final film.
That's while he was alive. The other one was finished.
Mr. Fury, right?
Yeah. Game of Death was his last film.
Yeah.
But they finished it after he was dead.
Oh, right.
The way the question's worded, it is
Enda. This is the final one completed before his death.
Wow.
Yeah. Made before his death. Okay, yes.
Yeah. Okay, so we're still going to go from top to bottom in this list, starting with Finn's Join NATO as Bitcoin Goes Helsinki.
Three.
Hmm. All right. Chinese hurricane cannons.
Nine.
Oh,
God.
I'm new leader. The Oxford Comma Appreciation Society.
Nine.
A new leader. In the land of Fermilab plus Karen.
For shame, we have nine instead of 10 because I should have caught it. No, Return of the Dragon instead of Enter. I don't know why I didn't think of that, guys.
And
I'm sorry.
Carl's Crazy Cat Kingdom, what did we get, guys?
10.
10!
Oh. And we're still in order.
Wait,
four
did
to
you
16.
Spell Tilda's name correctly?
Pitcher.
Okay, who can take a picture of the whole screen?
Usually it'll be
I think Leonard did it last time.
I think Carl did it last time. I did it last time because Leonard wasn't here.
Okay, Carl, you can do it then.
I can do it.
Wait, Caspian on screen.
It'll take me a second before I'm ready.
Where's Caspian?
Tell us when you're ready. Give us a 3, 2, 1 countdown.
Right. So we know when to smile. So we don't hurt our smile.
We need to know when to smile.
Food in our mouth.
All right. 3, 2, 1. Let's see. Look okay. Oh, nobody.
Kevin.
Okay. Faith is doing that on purpose, so we'll use that.
Oh, what was she doing? I didn't even see it. I'll have to see the picture.
I was smiling.
Send it to Susan. There we go.
Susan.
Oh, okay.
A quick break this time.
All right. Break time.
Quick break.
Quick. No, not allowed.
Wait, Susan, are you getting tired?
I'll be looking forward to getting home.
I bet.
Okay. Good night, you guys.
Yeah, I take off too.
Thank you.
Hope to see you guys again.
Thanks for showing up.
I hear chickens.
They've come home to roost.
Oh, Carl, did you put the answers in for round one?
Oh, I forgot to do that. No, for round one? Let's see.
Yeah, I think so.
Yeah, I did one. Yeah.
Okay. Got that
one. One and two.
Let's see one.
Yeah, okay. One. Yeah.
Do you need them, Rob? I can repost them back if you need
Here.
Them.
I can, well.
I mean, I have them all in a.
Yeah. At the end of the night, I'm going to upload files into the chat for all the rounds.
Okay, that's better. It'll be easier. It's actually hard. It's hard copying them into the spreadsheet from the chat because each one wants.
I always try and do that. So if anybody cares, see,
okay.
That's the thing.
Thank you.
Everybody has the ability to actually have all my answers on their computer ready to go. To study for the next time I do a trip.
Oh, hint.
They always have.
All right. Now I'm
going to do
that. I kind of feel like, though, that would be kind of cheating for the, just for your purposes.
Because I could have opened up all my documents with all the previous rounds in there, but, you know, I'm not going to do it. I'm so mad. We could have had a 10. Oh, well.
What did you get wrong again?
We had Return of the Dragon instead of Enter the Dragon. And I totally should have caught that. I should have known better.
I had a feeling that that was going to trip some people up because either one of those sounds right. Mm-hmm. They both sound right.
That's the thing. When we talked about it in our breakout room, I didn't even give it a second thought going, oh, no, it should be Enter, not Return, because it fit the theme and it sounded like a movie title. Yeah. So,
it was, in fact, a movie. Return of the Dragon was a Bruce Lee movie. So... Yeah. The fault was us not thinking about but it's the final one and Enter.
And either one would fit the theme, depending on your keyboard.
And I actually helped my team with that question. That was...
Yeah, Return of the Dragon was 1974. Enter the... Wait. Is that a different Return of the Dragon?
There's
Return of not a Bruce Dragon. Lee movie then, I guess.
Oh, there's Return of the Dragon was the U.S. name of Way of the Dragon, I guess.
Ah, yeah. Gotcha.
I don't know why I'm speaking so loudly. Sorry, Mom.
Sounds like you're a Bruce Lee fan, Avi.
No, I've never seen any Bruce Lee movies.
Uh-huh.
I just am quick on Wikipedia.
Uh-huh.
There is such a thing as dragons. Come on.
Quickipedia.
Quickipedia.
I'm currently looking at the article on Red Jungle Fowl.
Has anyone ever seen a Komodo dragon? They're quite big.
I don't think I've seen one in person. I don't know. Maybe does our zoo have them, Carl?
Probably.
I would think I've probably seen one at the zoo at one point.
Oh, they have them here. They have small versions here, only about 3 or 4 feet long. But we're going to go to Indonesia this year. There's an island that is completely covered with Komodo dragons. But because of COVID, all of our flights, everything was canceled. But it really, they're Indonesian.
In somewhere in the States, A Thousand Ways to Die, I think, was an old show. And one guy decided to keep Komodo dragons as pets, which was an incredibly stupid thing to do. And eventually they killed him and ate him.
Really?
Yeah. You don't want to keep a Komodo dragon as a pet because they're going to do instinctively what they're going to do.
I personally don't want any reptiles as pets, frankly. But
yeah. Oh, yeah. I found videos of Komodo dragons at St. Louis, so I've probably seen one when I was at the zoo.
Oh, that's great. A pop-up ad to help you get rid of ads.
That's
like mafia extortion. Be an awful shame if some ads were to pop up on your screen here.
That's Bruce Lee fighting Kareem Abdul-Jabbar.
Oh, yeah, I remember that.
Oh, yeah.
He ends up with a big giant footprint on his chest.
Does it just keep repeat? Oh.
No, that was me rewinding it.
Oh.
I think that's the movie. I'm not sure if that's Enter the Dragon. It's the one where he goes up to every floor.
He has
to find a different guy in every floor. The top of the building, and the last one's covered with mirrors.
Yeah, I don't remember which is which, but I remember that movie, definitely, in the multi-level stuff.
Yep.
Boy, it's been... somewhere between 30 and 40 years since I've seen that film.
Hi, George.
Look at the puppy.
Hi, George.
George.
Woof.
No, not interested. It's not naughty enough. He's got to do naughty.
Church, 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 church.
Do you hear that?
Hey, George. Hey, George.
So, does anybody's dog bark or growl when they see or hear another dog on TV?
I had a dog who did that repeatedly, and I couldn't watch anything with animals in it because he would go nuts.
My brother-in-law's dog goes nuts. And the other day, I was over at my brother-in-law's house. We were watching a movie. There was a dog in it, and like my brother-in-law's dog was like asleep, and we hear this dog, and my dog, like in his sleep, the dog goes. Yeah.
My dog was particularly hated horses. And so the horse races, I would try to watch a horse race and it was impossible. He would just lose it, completely lose it.
We had a beagle when I was growing up and we took it on a trip with us. And one of the places we went was Yellowstone where you got to actually see real bears.
Ooh.
And then we were at a different park and they were showing that movie, the bears. It was like a nature movie. It was outdoors. And so he was there with us. And when the bears scratching their butts on the trees scene came on, he started howling. I had to take him back to our camp because he was going, woo, woo.
My dog would bark at TV horses, but not real horses. Like he'd go out and see them and be fine, but TV horses were really
better sense than the challenge an actual real
horse. Yeah, they were kind of big.
There's a YouTube channel called Mousetrap Monday where the guy collects and tests all kinds of antiques and current mouse traps, and then people send him videos of their cats watching the mice on TV. It's pretty funny.
Okay, folks, everyone back?
In case anyone's wondering, I'm eating a BLT.
Mm.
Oh my makes God. Makes us jealous. Hi, Robin.
I have not had a BLT in two.
Hi, Robin.
Since the pandemic needs started. To be assigned to a room, Rob.
Damn.
Hi, Robin.
Robin needs a room.
How's everybody? Robin? Probably better than me. I'm a little sick.
What's going on?
I have COVID.
Oh, no.
But now you have symptoms.
Yes, I'm well, tonight, this afternoon, I'm sneezing a lot.
You look a little COVID-y.
Yeah.
How's your husband?
He's got a negative PCR test from yesterday, so he's doing great.
Well, he's doing better.
He feels fine.
He's over it. Over I'm it. In it.
He has passed the baton to you.
He's passed the baton to me. Thanks, Corey. Yeah.
Last week you didn't have any symptoms, did you? Robin, last week you didn't have any symptoms, did you?
No, last week, okay, so it was last Wednesday night that Corey tested positive. Mm. And I didn't have any symptoms until, well, I had a little bit of a runny nose on Tuesday, but like, it didn't make me think COVID.
When did you test positive, Robin?
Today, first time.
Just today, oh, okay.
Yeah, I've tested every day. So this is my eighth test, all negative until today.
So you had at least an 8-day incubation before symptoms.
Or I've been contagious for the last 8 days and have given it to everyone under the
sun. Well, I understand, but I'm trying to figure out for us what the newer incubation period is, because I'm not very comfortable with what we saw going on at the hospital, and we've just been a week in the hospital. Hmm. So I've told people, don't come by us until we go through that incubation period.
How's your husband doing?
We dodged a bullet.
Hi, Robin. So
today he's trying to go without oxygen. You know, like supplemental oxygen. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
I figured he didn't have a mutation that was going to allow him to live without oxygen.
I must be quite the hospital. I wouldn't be so judgmental.
Yeah, thank you for that clarification.
And he's trying to start moving around more, so we will see.
Okay.
We're thinking there's not been heart and lung damage, but it was serious.
Hopefully. Okay. All right. Well, I'm trying to put Robin in room one, and for some reason, you're not even in the breakout room list. I don't understand what's going on.
We can really use her.
Yeah, well, yeah. You're in last by a little bit, so yes. Sorry, Robin. You're gonna have an uphill climb with the team, but maybe I can't do it until the rooms are open.
I don't think you can do it until the rooms are open.
Yeah. What the hell's wrong with Zoom? I don't understand it. Okay, so we're ready for the third round. No, we need announcements. Announcements. Yes,
Kyle.
I almost forgot. Kyle, are you there, Kyle? Or are you frozen?
Oh, sure. I am indeed. Yeah, lately I need a skeptic. Hello? Am I muted?
Hi. You're good.
Nope, you're all good. Right.
I was making a joke, sorry.
Latest episode on Data Skeptics, all about how learning things have been doing remotely. Now that we've had a couple years, we can look at data and statistics on whether or not people are able to work and live remotely and learn remotely. So yet another interview this week on that topic.
Someone needs to be muted.
Robin, you need to mute yourself.
Stop sign. So,
Robin?
Yep, definitely Robin.
Yeah. Okay, good. Any other announcements?
Anybody? I've been doing a bunch of tour stuff. There's a whole bunch of videos.
So that wasn't Robin. Where's that?
No, Robin is unmuted. No. Now
so
she's
a lot
again.
Of videos of up in different places that you can watch of the stuff I've done and stuff. So.
All right.
That's it.
And so tomorrow it's a talk in Colorado, and then what next?
Home.
Okay, that's the last one. The last one on your long tour.
I've been on I've been gone 16 days, I think.
Yeah, and then she's
forever.
then she's going to come visit Germany and give a talk to me.
So okay. Who's been feeding and watering Mark while you're gone? Yes.
The cats won't recognize you.
Aww.
Oh, okay.
Round an automatic water for Mark.
Round three, Mr. with a K.
Okay. So, round three. Hold on a second here. Get the PowerPoint ready to go. There's going to be a PowerPoint associated with that I will play through, and then you can get to it from the chat. You can test out whether you can get to that or not.
What is the category?
The category is
cuckoo clocks.
Guns of science fiction.
Cuckoo clocks, yeah.
Guns of science fiction. And are we using guns loosely?
Well, you'll see. It's not particularly loose. So let's see. Share screen. All right. Here we go. Identify the movie or TV show the weapon belongs to. Number one. Number two. Number three. Number four. Wow. Number five. Number six. Number seven. Number eight. Number nine. Number 10. And a bonus for maximum score of 10. That.
Wow, Bob. Yeah, Carl. Bob, I was hearing chickens, but you look like you were muted, so I'm confused. Does the other device you have an audio on it?
He was muted. He was unmuted before.
Oh, okay. Okay. So Carl, yet again, you beat me to a category ahead of my possible category list.
Oh, thank God. We'll never have to do this again.
No, but in fact, I started and I said, oh no, this is too hard. I'm not doing this. so thank you, Carl.
Well, I would have been the third because I was thinking about this as well. Cause if you've seen, I think I showed it on screen one time. I have that t-shirt that has all the different blasters that makes up a picture of a bigger blaster, and I was like, oh, I should do that sometime. And I'm like, oh, Carl did. Never mind.
Carl said that his first round was the hard round.
Uh-huh.
Right.
I'm on one team.
Liar for who?
Son of a gun.
Go to our rooms.
All right. So let's
see. All right.
Do we have the pictures somewhere? Do we have to
there's a link to the
great
Google Docs in the chat.
Yep.
And hopefully, if anybody can't get to it, at least one person in each room should be able to get to it and share it out to share their screen out to everyone else.
I put you in room one, Robin. You're gone. You got it? Okay, good. Okie dokie. No one's back yet. Alan. Alan?
Hey. Yeah.
Hello, Alan.
Hello, oh,
you're driving, huh?
Yeah, I can hardly hear you. I hope the sound's really low here. I don't know why you're not on my thing here.
You shouldn't be looking at it if you're driving.
No, well, I'm not moving yet. I'm sitting in the parking lot, so. So, well, where are you guys at this point?
Are you on our team?
We're doing round three.
Yeah, but I don't know why I can't hear you guys.
No, so Alan's not on any team.
Right. He can't be on our team.
Well, I don't know how long I'm going to last anyway. I'm just driving home and it's been a long day. I may just crash. Is Avi still around?
Avi left.
Just left.
He did. Okay. Well, he got in an extra round, I guess.
Yeah, he stayed for his typical two, actually.
We should get him to do a round tonight. Put him on round four.
I don't know how to say, I'm not sure if this is going to work if I can't get it to the sound. Oh, I know. Hang on a second. Kevin, talk to me.
Yeah, what's up?
Can you okay. Hear? Yeah, no. Yeah, I didn't have the sound on. So what is this a team? Am I on a team? What am I on?
No, not yet.
This is the main room. We just came back. Everyone else is still in their team rooms.
All right.
And we're the leaders, so you won't be on our team.
No.
All right.
In fact, it's a very high likelihood you're going to be on the team that is almost 10 points behind everyone already.
Well, that's okay. I wouldn't have been any help anyway. Well, what's the current category?
This is Guns of Science Fiction. So Karl created a file, a PowerPoint presentation with 11 pictures of weapons, and we have to name the show or a movie.
Oh, that sounds like a Karl thing.
Yeah, it was almost a Rob thing until Rob decided it was too difficult, but Karl went for it anyway. So we'll see. I think we did reasonably, but
yeah, I think we did all right, but I don't. We didn't get them all. I don't think for sure. So,
don't think anyone got a 10.
No, I don't think so.
Out of 11, even.
Well, have there been any zeros today?
There was a one.
There was a one, but not a zero.
And no Uncle Ron.
Yeah. Oh, Avi, you're there. I thought, yeah, I know. He's watching the
hockey. Oh, I thought you were gone, Avi.
Yeah.
No, I'm.
This is going to be your last round. This is going to be your last round.
I will see how tired I am after this round because
he's having so much fun. He's going to stick it out.
It's actually
so nice having you for extra rounds, Avi.
Yeah, I mean, I like usually if you notice when I leave for. It's usually around like 11:15 my time or so, but it's still 10:30 here this time.
Ooh, right.
It's a lot earlier than I'm used to going through.
You're in the same time zone as me for once.
Yep.
So this is a dilemma. We have Alan joining very late and the team with three people, the lowest number of people is in the lead. So can't do it that way. I'll have to do it with the low score. It. But the team with the low score already has an overwhelming majority of people. So
nobody from the leading team is leaving, are they?
This is weird.
No, we'll have to figure out what happens.
Maybe you should wait. Round. You should wait till after we do scores in this round before you figure it out.
Yes.
Well, now what round number is this?
Three.
We don't know. When I get home, I may fall on my face, and that'll be it. I won't even.
Okay, pay attention to the road. All right, you ready for the answers, everybody?
Yeah.
Yes.
Yep.
All right. So before I get into showing all the answers, I'd just like to show you a picture from Susan's own Facebook feed that has a particular gun in it. Oh, there we go.
Firefly.
I didn't look at that. And then, let's see here.
He's just trying to embarrass me, you guys.
Yeah.
Star Trek. Question. Star Trek was originally
sing that song. Could you sing that song, Susan? That Manny by Elton John.
Oh, Manny, you hate me. Oh, Manny.
Star Trek was originally billed as Wagon Train to the Stars by Gene Roddenberry.
And then here's another Firefly picture actually of Susan standing right next to
there an we answer. Go.
But some of us were able to deduce that, Karl.
In other words, he's trying to say, I should know better.
I don't consider Clue to be science fiction.
Did you take a picture of that from that poster? Like, did you like take a picture of it while you were there?
I took those pictures. I didn't.
Wait, but did Karl, did you like go and actually take a picture surreptitiously of this while you were there with her?
So he said, this is going to be the catalog.
I just took a picture of her. I already had the whole round done before we discovered exhibit.
With that in it already, or did you add that?
Yes, no, that was in it already.
Oh, okay.
And it was pure coincidence that we... I'm like, holy crap, there.
So who knew there was a Firefly?
I have to have a picture of Susan in front of this.
So was it like it really is a Firefly clue. So was it like Reverend Book in the cafeteria with a Bible?
I guess so.
There you go. I like it.
All right. Can everyone see my PowerPoint here?
No.
Yeah.
No. Not yet.
Not yet.
All right, hold on a second.
I use my inner eye.
Get back here to Zoom. Share screen.
The next category can have the same images, but how many hit points it does.
I like it.
Please put the answers in the chat as well.
I will put the answers in the chat after I go through the PowerPoint, definitely. All right. Number one, Star Trek.
The Menagerie, Cage.
Seriously?
Oh, gosh. Shit.
Minute has gone before.
No, yep.
Both of them.
No freaking way.
Yep.
It's so funky.
Number two, Blake 7.
Oh, I called it. I remember this. And that's
what the hell is that? What is that?
You should put those bracelets on.
The bracelets. That's their idea of a gun.
It's a terrible idea for a gun.
Three is Blade Runner.
It makes their hair look like that.
Why are there multiple triggers? Blade 7 guns, you could see that there's a telephone cord plugging into their belt.
Yeah.
What? Why is there multiple triggers?
Precision aiming, you get a hair trigger.
It's got an underbarrel.
Of course, here's
1994. Right time frame.
We said it, but
we put it in the wrong one.
Got that on the wrong one.
I know where I've seen those little buttons before. They're on my heating pad.
Yeah. Would have accepted that as an answer.
That is an auto pipette.
The Fifth Element for number 5. Not coincidental that ended up being number five. That's not even a
comedy.
Yeah, that was an easily recognizable one.
Damn.
Yeah, sure.
Number 6, Firefly or Serenity?
So do we get 2 points if we put both Firefly and Serenity?
Just one.
We
got them mixed up.
7, V!
Yay!
Hey,
I got that one.
Got that right.
Look at that.
The original one.
Yes!
Number 8.
Yay!
Got that right. The cast members call the penis gun.
Are there Egyptians in this show, Karl?
Oh, yeah.
Yes.
Oh, yes.
Is that all American? Ramiro, you got with yep.
Ben and I may have been to a few Stargate conventions.
Oh.
Nerds.
Aliens, I'll accept. The aliens yes. or the aliens.
Hey, I think we got that one, didn't we?
I think we did.
Yeah, I know we got that.
Even though the movie Alien would be incorrect, I'll accept anything Alien.
Oh, come on, Karl.
No, that's fine. 10, Forbidden Planet.
Oh,
we guessed.
Only funky.
We guessed a Flash Gordon.
Flash Gordon.
Yes.
Too. We said Mark.
Because it looked Mark's like that
Flash
era.
Gordon did not make the final cut. Battlestar Galactica.
That's the Battlestar Galactica.
Battlestar Ponderosica.
Yeah.
That's why I recognized him, but didn't recognize him. Oh, yeah. Sorry, team.
It's all right.
We got a couple more than I thought we would.
Okay, not bad.
I think we got two.
Actually, we got better than I guess we were going to. Yeah, okay, I'm let's not see. Happy, but, oh well. Share screen. Okay. Still starting from the top. It's still from the top to the bottom. This is amazing. Okay.
That's kind of crazy.
Finns join NATO as Bitcoin goes Helsinki.
Three.
Oh, staying on track.
We got to be consistent.
Chinese hurricane cannons.
Two. We fucked up the rotation.
Oh, look, we're ahead of somebody in one round.
Could have just thrown them up in the air and reorganized.
We would have done better because we did have some of the right ones. They were in the wrong place. Yeah.
The Oxford Comma Appreciation Society.
Five.
Taking the lead in the land of Fermilab.
Stop the count.
Seven.
Too late. And a new leader by quite a bit. And let's see if that holds Carl's crazy cat kingdom.
Seven.
And we're still in order. This is amazing. Okie dokie.
Hey, at least my team isn't in last place. So hey, gotta.
Yeah, we're in middle.
Hey, Rob, why don't you put me on Avi's team? Because when I get home, I'm just gonna sit with him in the kitchen anyway. So
woohoo!
Still there. So
no, you have to be on different teams, even though you're right next to each other.
No.
I'm pretty sure, even though they have about 20 people already, I need to put you on the team with 7 points. Sorry.
No.
We did not okay, going to have to sit in the back of
your Dagon's home.
You ready for round number four, Carl?
All right. So I got the answers in there. And at the end of the night, I will post in the documents with the full original, all the questions and answers if anyone cares.
Please don't forget to do that. I need to put it in Susan's spreadsheet right. Or show
you. So that was three. So now we move to round four. I don't have the title of in the document.
What is round four?
It's the round after three.
It is another mystery theme.
Yay!
TV show mystery theme round.
Yay!
TV show mystery.
I like to
theme
think
round.
This one's pretty easy, but.
All answers are
there. Famous last words. So.
Whoa, something weird just happened in my file. Hold on one sec. Oh, man. What the? That was weird. Okay, muting everybody. Yeah.
What about next week?
Three, two, one. Oh, yeah. Later. So after this, we'll figure that out.
All right. Question number one. Basically, every single one of these is name the TV show from The Clue. 1979 to 85, the adventures of a pair of brothers on probation for bootlegging. Number two, 1982 to 86, a lone crime fighter battles the forces of evil with the help of an artificial intelligence voiced by William Daniels. Number three, 1983 to 86, starring Brian Keith as a retired judge who joins up with his last defendant to follow up on cases that were dismissed due to technicalities. And we're letting Richard Saunders in the room.
Okay, hold on just a minute to Richard.
Yeah.
Can you hear us, Richard?
Yeah.
Welcome. Okay. Carl just started the round, so...
Yeah, I'm gonna repaste these for Richard.
Repaste the first three. Okay.
Thank you. Hi, Susan. Hi, everyone.
One for Richard.
Hi, Richard.
Number two for Richard.
32 days and counting, and I'll be in Oregon. Woohoo!
Ooh.
Woohoo!
Three for Richard. And now, starting with number four, which I will now read.
Okay, muting everybody again.
Did you mute everything? All right. 1980 to 1988, the adventures of a Hawaii-based private investigator. Oh, yeah, Richard, this is a mystery theme round. Identify the team show, the TV shows from the clue, and they all fit into a theme. Number five, 1990 to 95. A bumbling childlike man who has trouble completing the simplest of tasks in day-to-day life, but his perseverance and resourcefulness frequently allow him to find ingenious ways around problems. That's perseverance, to pronounce that correctly. Number six, a 1966 to 68 show that guest starred Cesar Romero, Frank Gorshin, and Vincent Price as various bad guys. Number seven, 1983 to 87, four Vietnam vets framed for a crime they didn't commit help the innocent while on a run for the military. Number eight, 1975 to 79, two streetwise cops bust criminals with the help of their snitch. Number nine, 1966 to 67, a newspaper publisher and his Asian valet slash martial arts expert battle crime. Number 10. '69 to 1970, a group of teenage friends and their dog travel around solving strange and hilarious mysteries. It's a great primer in skepticism. I want the proper title. If and only if nobody gets the proper title, I may be lenient in what I will accept as a correct title. Number 11. What is the theme? And there we go.
Didn't you just tell me the theme when I joined?
There is a common theme to all these questions.
Okay. All right. Any questions?
Nope.
It says I'm muted, but I'm not muted.
It's clearly. Like there's 11 of them.
You just answered me.
There are 11. 10 points maximum.
Okay. Here we go. Open the breakout rooms. Good luck. Oh, Richard, sorry to do this to you. You're gonna go to a room, but you're gonna be surprised that they're in last place because they have so many people, but apparently they need more. So here you
go. All right.
Good luck. Did you get your thing, Alan? Are you gonna play? Oh, you can't because you're driving anyway. But I put you in a room. Doing. I don't know why Deborah and Kyle are still here. What happened? Kyle, Deborah, Alan, why is nobody hearing me? Okay, I don't know what's going on here. Deborah, there were two of you. Now there's one of you. There's still two of you.
It wouldn't go to the room, so it kicked me back.
So you don't have the option to join the room? You're in room one, right?
That's right.
Okay. And I don't know why Alan is not answering me, so I don't know if he's frozen or off or what, but I'm going to my room. Do you have the thing there, Deborah, now? Oh, boy. What's going on? Kyle, it's your one. Hi, Kyle. Did you Zoom crash or something? Kyle, I don't know if it's me or else, but nobody's working here. What's going on? What's going on, Deborah, Kyle? Can anybody hear me, Alan?
I keep getting an error and it kicks me out.
I don't know what to do.
I don't either. You know what it says? I haven't been assigned. So you may have to reassign me.
It keeps saying error when I try and go into mine and then closes the thing.
Your other thing is still here. I'm going to delete those first this time before I stick you somewhere.
That's a good idea.
Okay, let's try it now.
It says the host is open breakout rooms. Please wait to be assigned. So
okay, so you're going to one. And okay. Kyle is going, you were both in one, right?
Yep.
Yes.
Okay, do you see a thing now? Hello? Oh, freak. It's like you froze again.
Did you get booted too, Deborah?
Again, yeah.
What's I got, same here. I got booted.
Oh no!
Now I need Rob to make me an admin again so I can get into rooms. I'm guessing something's going on with the Zoom infrastructure.
Seems like it.
Yeah. It's weird too, because tonight I couldn't join through Facebook. I had to do it through Zoom itself. It's the only time I think I've ever done that. It's because the join through Facebook didn't work at all. Just it would act like it was clicking, but it didn't work. And now you and I are both here twice, Kyle.
Oh yeah.
Let's see what's that.
Is there a way we can send a message to Rob?
I don't know. Let's see. Chat.
Chat record.
Apps.
I don't see. I can't get to any of the breakout rooms. Therefore, I can't ask for help.
And he's in. The only people listed in the chat are us.
Oh, I know what I can do.
There you go.
Wait, Karl, were you just calling Ben?
Yes. Because I have his number memorized. And I am having him contact Rob through Zoom.
Why did you need to have him contact Rob?
Because I got kicked out and I need to be turned back into an administrator.
Yeah, let me, can I even message him? Because Rob's not in here. Oh,
now that you're not in a room, probably not.
You can join back into the breakout room and do ask for help.
Oh, can I? Okay. Sorry.
I'll be right back.
I like being able to walk around. I'm no longer in this tiny studio apartment where I could hold out my hands and I'd be one end of this apartment to the other.
What room am I in?
The main room.
Okay, this is freaking weird. I just tried to send somebody to a room and it sent me and I bounced out.
You look like
Susan for 1 second, Rob.
Rob, you need to make Karl a VIP again.
What happened to Karl?
He got kicked out.
We think there's a Zoom glitch going on. We're all having some technical issues.
Yeah. Also, my dad was kept getting kicked out on his phone.
Well, that's three people at once, and it was like disrupting my whole helping my team because I was trying to help him, Kyle, and Deborah, who just kept going in and out. I don't know what I
was trying. That was crazy.
We couldn't help our team at all because we never could get there.
Yeah.
Anyone still in a room? Yeah.
I came back. I saw you for like a split second, Rob, and then you left. And I'm like, well, hopefully he's back in the main room and can help Karl.
So, Kyle, what was happening when I sent the thing to join the room and what happened?
It would spin for a minute and then I would get an error message and it would kick me out of Zoom.
Same exact thing here.
Hmm. So it seems like I'm not going to be able to send you to the rooms anymore. It's just going to keep happening. I don't understand it.
I was able to join back to my room, but I never got kicked out. So maybe it's only affecting people that actually got bounced.
Well, let's try it again one more time here. Send to room one. Deborah, sent to room one.
All right.
Okay.
Is it working? See, this is what happens. They freeze.
So they did leave. But are they stuck in limbo?
No, Kyle is now in room one. At least it says he is.
Oh, well, that's good.
As are Deborah, so it may have worked. Okay, maybe it worked this time. Maybe it was a temporary glitch and no one could do it in the whole world in Zoom just for that few minutes.
I'm wondering if they had some sort of momentary outage / blip. And what is Avi eating? I must know. What is it about seeing someone eat on camera that you're like, I must know what you're eating? Oh, yeah. Sea salt. Good stuff. Fox Susan Gerbic is the host now. And then he left. All right, anyone in our room that's not us? I don't think so. Walking and eating, that'll keep you awake, right, Avi? No? Okay. It's like, I'm going to fall asleep standing up. We're actually doing pretty well. It's only 11, and we're already to almost done and to the bonus round. Bob looks sleepy, too. He just shakes his head. You don't need to unmute for that. You just shake your head. Oh, yeah. I see the chicken closing their eyes, too. Now, do you have to move the chicken to a sleeping spot, or will it just stay there and sleep all night?
I could do either. He would sleep on the chair. I used to leave them. They would on the other chair. They would sit side by side on the back and sleep up there all night.
Oh, cool!
And then I would come down and grab them. They can walk over there, but if they were still sitting up on this thing, I would. Because it was dark in here, so they couldn't tell what time it was.
Right. Oh, is that the thing? Because that'd be the downside is having a chicken inside your house when they crow would be bad.
Well, he does, yeah. But it's not that loud. You know, it doesn't even bother my wife.
Oh, really? But are you down in the basement? So are you like
I'm in the basement, levels? Yeah.
Yeah, so you're...
And she sleeps on the first floor. She's almost not quite... She's a couple feet that way directly above the next floor up is where she actually is. So yeah, it doesn't even bother her. And I can hear it all the way up on the second floor.
Wow.
So yeah. But he's not nearly as loud as the ones that live outside.
Oh yeah.
They're smaller, so they're not super loud like a full size 8-pound rooster would be. Uh-huh. They're a little maybe they're a little bigger than him. But they do a full, long, traditional crow. This crow just kind of chokes off. He gets started, and then it ends in a kind of a little, you know, choke, strangled sound, you know, where it just kind of bottoms out. So it's not that bad. And he's tiny, so it's not nearly as loud. So, but yeah, he about 5:30, you'll hear him. When I went up during the break, I left him on the seat, but he got up, went over, jumped up in the box, ate, got a drink of water. And then when I came back, he came back out, walked back over, came in. So he's not there. Oh, okay. I'll go.
Yeah, like Karl, he's probably talked about it on trivia nights and how his cats are totally trained and they have a routine. Like, you know, they stay down in the basement with him and then they know when it's time to go upstairs and get ready for bed and they go up the stairs with him. Do you have powers?
Has been triggered.
Do you have powers, Karl?
I have powers.
That's good.
Rob's on top of that.
What?
I said Rob is on top of that. I have powers again.
But you can have multiple hosts, right? Or are they just considered co-hosts? Or how does that work?
Co-hosts. One host, yeah. Multiple co-hosts.
I gotcha. That's right. Okay. Well, we'll have to see if we get the bonus or the theme right, because I don't know how specific... You need us to be with the
theme. I know at least one or more groups have a correct theme, and last I checked, one or more groups had not figured the theme out correctly.
Mm-hmm.
Man, these were tough. I'm scratching my head who the snitch was. I can't remember his name.
Oh, well, we can't are we allowed to talk about that?
When I get to the
Snitchy McSnick Trace?
Yes, no, exactly.
I keep thinking it's
stitches. Oh, I got a flower. I got
stitches. The boat stitches.
All right.
Hey, look, there's Alan.
Avi is literally passing the
ball. Oh, I know what it is. HB. I know.
Yeah, you got it.
Oh, look at this little thing. Look at that cutie look.
The original version of that question had the name of the snitch in it, but I chose to remove the snitch.
Yeah, that was tough. I just got it now. HB is his initials.
Yep. No idea.
Okay, is everybody back? No, they're not yet.
Doesn't look like it.
No, they're not. What are they doing? What's going on?
How much time is left? 20 seconds. Count me down. Tick, 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 tick. Uh-oh, two teams are not ready to come back.
That Jake?
Too bad.
How you doing, buddy? How you doing, buddy? What time is it over there?
Now everybody's back.
We don't need to know. There we go.
Okay, I'm going to guess everybody's going to get 10.
I don't think so.
There may be a 10 or two, but there won't be all 10.
Okay, give us the good news. I think we did reasonably well.
I will post in the answers at the end, but I will show you the answers first in a PowerPoint. Can you see this?
Yes.
You see something.
Pixelated. Number one,
the Dukes of Hazzard.
Just a good old boy.
And if you don't know the theme, you should get it halfway through the answers. Number two, Knight Rider. Number three, Hardcastle and McCormick.
Oh. Overrated TV series.
Oh, God, it was
when you're a little kid.
Does something really stupid count?
Oh, yeah. No.
Magnum P.I.
I knew that was the Tom Selleck.
Now, number five, Mr. Bean.
What? Y'all.
I'm trying to think the theme of the cars. You're joking.
Will you take Ernest P. Worrell with your
Mr. Bean.
Mr. That's not a fancy car.
See, there's all number these six, cars. Yeah, we missed the Batman. Theme of cars. The Batmobile.
Number seven, the A-Team.
Well, that's obvious now.
Number eight, Starsky and Hutch.
I got that one too.
Oh, number nine, the Green Hornet.
Oh, great job.
Oh, there we go.
And Scooby-Doo, where are you? And you have to have it because I know at least one team got it.
I got it. Scooby-Doo, where are you?
You had it.
I don't mean to disparage the TV shows. I was only talking about Dukes of Hazzard.
TV shows, also. Iconic vehicles.
We have another
commonality, though, and I think unless
Mr. Bean, they all became movies.
All became movies.
No. Hardcastle McCormick did not become a movie.
That's the one.
Mr. Bean was not a crime fighter.
Oh, no, Monk's not in there. No.
No one died.
Well, how come you don't have the monkeys and the monkeys and
what about the Adam's family?
The Munsters car.
Because there's only 10 items. 10 or 11.
They were on the long list, but they didn't make the final cut.
Okay, so that we might come back to them
in the future.
So.
All right, team, we missed the theme because we guessed Monk for number five.
We guessed Monk and I changed it to Mr. Bean.
I don't think we would have got the team. Monk
know how to drive, I don't think.
Alrighty, still at this stage of the game, from top to bottom.
That's so weird.
All right, team number one.
We've never seen that pattern before.
Finn's joining as Bitcoin goes hell sinky.
We got 9.
Yes, breaking them all.
Bam, I changed things.
Double digits,
finally.
Finally.
Not in last place yet, right now. Chinese hurricane cannons.
8.
Oh, back to last place. Sorry, Finn's joined NATO. The Oxford Comma Appreciation Society?
7.
Take the lead.
Hey.
In the Land of Fermilad plus Karen?
11.
Oh.
10 10, okay.
New lead. And, is that lead going to stick? And breaking the sequence.
Oh.
And apparently
I don't
not.
Like it. Yeah. I don't like it. I demand a recount.
This is hysterical.
The Kevin has one more point.
Kind of like one more point. Kentucky Derby.
And it's all Blake 7's fault, Karl.
The really bad thing, Karl's crazy cat, is if we fall out of first place now in the bonus round.
Look at Abby is still awake.
Mr. Bean for number 4.
Yeah, I'm gonna stay for the last round. It's
all right.
Are
you ready?
Alrighty, yes, let's do it. Final round. So, what is the bonus?
We had first one was hard, second one was kind of easy.
We got to win
this one. Hard. Next one was kind of easy.
No.
Who knows what this one will be?
Oh, come on.
So a few weeks ago, Rob had an answer that was the S&P 500. And so that's an index of 500 of the largest publicly traded companies in the U.S. stock market. So name any 10 of the top 12 largest publicly traded U.S. companies by market capitalization.
By what?
By market capitalization. That means what its value is according to the stock market if you wanted to buy every single share of it.
Yeah, so total shares times stock price, basically. Yep.
Okay. Any questions?
No. And this is as of market close today. And the reason why I give you 12 is because basically the last three have been varying a lot in this volatile market in the past week.
Well, of course. Well, everyone knows that.
Any 10 of the top 12.
All right. Good luck. Okay, so let me go to room 5.
hey, same people I was saw a few minutes ago.
Yeah. Welcome back. We should do well for this round. Great, Susan. Thanks for making something like this.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You're can't really hear you. You're not muted, but you're very, very quiet.
Same. It wasn't supposed to be a thing.
Yeah, we can.
Then people said, that was fun. Can we do it again?
Oh, there. Now we can hear you again.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
And now it's been two years, right?
Oh. Yep, coming up on them.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Good. It's something that I can look for. I actually look forward to it. And
you know, I've heard a lot of that, and I look forward to it, obviously, too. Yeah. I've heard lots of people say, when I went and saw Faith and Romero, I mean, we stayed with them, Adrian and I, and they took us all over the city and stuff, and they said, when we left, I think Faith said, this has been the best thing that's happened to us during the pandemic.
Yeah. It's
trivia.
It's because I don't really, this... Sunday, I'm actually going to go to a meetup for introverts, which I mean is kind of a misnomer, but it is for like-minded people for the most part, except for the religious ones, which I try to avoid talking about religion. So,
but you know, there's an awful lot of introverts in this group.
Yeah, and that's why I like it here. And I'm actually going to go somewhere to an introverts group. I am actually going to pick somebody up.
Oh, interesting.
Ride the places. So, yeah. Mm-hmm. It's been.
Oh, I'm glad you found us, Vincent. It's you're a nice addition to the group. It's fun. And you've been very helpful on our team tonight.
Yeah. Well,
you've been very helpful.
I don't know. I don't
absolutely know. Absolutely very helpful.
Oh well, thank you. I don't think I'm not really that smart, but
I didn't say you were smart. I said you were helpful.
Ah, yeah, there. That indeed. Is true. Yeah, you did say that.
Yeah, and being smart is different than being knowledgeable.
Yeah, that's true.
So I saw a posting from MIT Press on Facebook for a book called Black Holes. And someone made some bizarre comment saying that black holes, supernovas. And someone made a bizarre comment saying that supernovas are not caused by exploding stars. They're caused by stars forming plasma layers of different polarity. And when the polarity gets ruptured, they emit large amounts of energy. And I asked where he got this idea, and he starts going off on this insane electric universe nonsense, which if you've never heard of it, you're in great shape.
Oh, I've heard of that. Who are we talking about?
Yeah,
some guy that I happened to converse with on Facebook mm-hmm. today.
His books on that subject, that the universe is electric, not gravitational.
Yeah. He said, do your own research. Start here with a book on the electric universe. Mm-hmm. And I said, well, in fact, I have done my own research. I have a PhD in astrophysics.
Did he say goodbye?
No, he said, big deal. Who cares? I can predict the entire universe. Or map the entire universe.
Map? What does that mean?
Map. I don't know. And I said, that's quite a claim. And he said, isn't it?
Yeah.
And he sent me a list, half a dozen screenshots of all sorts of weird shit. Claiming that Egyptian hieroglyphics talk about electrical energy and things on Mars, and it's
that sounds like a very colorful conversation.
There are crazy people in the world.
Can you talk about the Egyptian guy in the spacecraft?
No, that's a different set of craziness.
A different crazy.
Yeah, Mike.
I had a friend that posted something on her Facebook. She's a school teacher. And it was, the cardinals are here, so my aunts come to visit. And I said, just birds. And she got so mad. Birds? Oh, my God. She just,
oh, yeah.
Did you say?
All her friends, I said, just birds.
Just birds, yeah.
And she said, blocked, you're a jerk. And all her friends started attacking me. How dare you? You soulless monkey.
What's that mean? Just birds.
Kinds of names.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Why did that infuriate people, Kevin? I don't understand.
Because they were saying that the cardinals were their dead relatives visiting them on the front lawn. And I said, no.
St. Louis.
How dare you attack my beliefs? And I says, show me one proof of evidence that.
That's what I thought, Caspian.
I thought birds weren't real anyway.
Yeah, birds aren't real.
The bird thing is a really common thing that happens to people after somebody dies.
Butterflies.
But then one of my friends from Australia said, we don't have cardinals analysis in Australia, so that means we have no angels there either.
Well, no, they have different things for angels.
Kangaroos, I bet. Yeah.
Kangaroos, yes. Right.
Yeah. Wait, they're reincarnated into birds? Is this literally the relative?
Yes. Kangaroos are reincarnated into birds.
That's the reason.
Which is a lot easier.
Is real?
But it's a lot. Parted relative is covered with mites.
Yeah, it's a lot easier for kangaroos to be reincarnated into birds than you'd think, because all of Africa is actually in New Mexico.
What?
That's right.
Yeah. Sorry, all of Australia is actually in New Mexico.
Yeah, it's in a zoo somewhere, right?
I
wonder when someone thinks like, okay, that bird is my dead grandfather, and then a hawk comes down and kills that bird.
Your grandfather just killed my grandfather.
The dead uncle that never liked the grandfather.
Well, you see what happens is the dead birds have just opened your dead grandfather's phylactery, and his soul has been released back on the
Thank you. Oh, God. That makes sense. Okay, Karl.
Or you think back at, you know, grandfather. All right. Oh,
so we start at the bottom up or the top down?
Yes.
Whatever.
Top down.
Start from the middle.
Just go slow so I can put an X or a...
Do them alphabetical.
In front of the wrong ones and right.
Just go slow.
All right.
Just go slow.
So starting at the top with the largest, there are four companies in the Trillion Club. Wow. Starting with Apple.
Yeah.
Since I've had every iPhone since the first one, thank you. Thank you very much.
Moving on to Microsoft.
Yay.
Yep.
I can't believe we forgot Microsoft.
No, we didn't.
What?
Oh, we did? We got it?
Moving on to Alphabet, otherwise known as Google.
Yes.
So you can accept both?
I will take either Alphabet or Google.
Okay.
That's fine. Amazon.
Yes.
Yes.
And for the next one, I will mention a little piece of trivia. Inside trivia. The S&P 500 is not technically the 500 largest companies in the U.S. stock market, because the Standard & Poor's Committee put certain filters in place, and even still, they can just decide not to include a company. So until relatively recently, they refused to put Tesla in the S&P 500. And when they did, it instantly became one of the 10 largest companies in the S&P 500. Which really caused some chaos in index funds. Next, we have Berkshire Hathaway.
That's
who the hell?
Warren Buffett's company.
Warren Buffett. Okay, yeah.
They own Geico, among other things.
Geico, flight safety, all sorts of insurance companies. They own lots and lots of stuff.
Yes, yes.
Meta. Otherwise known as Facebook.
Facebook, yes.
Yep.
Rumble.
Johnson & Johnson.
Oh. You could have had a good pharmaceutical.
Oh. United Healthcare.
Another healthcare.
Oh. We took that off.
We took that off.
Visa.
Damn. Oh, we forgot credit cards.
They have a one letter.
Got six.
Wow.
They have a one letter stock ticker. Those are very valuable. Walmart.
Oh, yeah. Sorry, Karen. This is sorry, Karen.
And down to the last one in the list. NVIDIA.
Really?
What?
What's that? They still exist.
Graphic cards. What do you mean they still exist? They're huge.
Thing in 2021.
They're gonna buy ARM.
Tech company.
Yeah. This is because of Bitcoin.
And after NVIDIA, the next company is about $40 billion less. And there's a link to the list.
NVIDIA is.
You're all roommate going to be
wow.
This is Bitcoin.
We might have a come from behind winner on this one.
No.
I hope not, but we might.
What's NVIDIA do again?
They make graphic cards.
They make chips.
Will you take the top 14, Carl?
No.
Okay. Here we go. This horse race. We'll see what happens. Not the one I wanted to share.
Still, and we're still top to bottom order.
Where is it? Where is it? Why don't I have it open? Because it's a lot.
I'm pretty sure we're going to stay that way, too.
Yeah, I think so.
We will unless we don't.
There we go. All right, let's see if this says the top to bottom. Finns join NATO as Bitcoin goes Helsinki.
Six.
Oh.
No.
Sorry. Chinese hurricane cannons.
Nine.
Ooh.
Nice.
Ooh, nice.
Very nice.
Not quite the lead. The Oxford Comma Appreciation Society?
10.
Wow.
Oh. Nice. Because we had Leonard.
Wow.
Leonard Vincent. Wow. I didn't do anything.
Can they hold it, people, in the land of Fermilab plus Karen?
Six.
Get in the lead and let's see, we're coming up to the finish line. Carl's Crazy Cat Kingdom.
Seven.
Oh,
Team top to bottom.
And they're all even numbers.
Wow.
Yeah, they are even numbers.
Oh, wow.
That's 32,
cool.
22, 32, 36, 38, 40. Amazing. I think that's a first.
That's so funny.
Fun game. Good categories, Carl.
Right.
Good job.
All the categories have been uploaded into the chat if anyone cares to download them.
I do, at least. Thank you.
He did a really good job because we spent 3 days together. So it's all
good. I had everything done before you arrived.
Yeah, but I inspired you because you had so many others that you didn't do.
Thank you very much for the game.
Okay, so what's next week? You want me to do it? Or you got other people?
Yeah,
have
to go.
So as far as I know, there's nobody on the schedule, Susan, and it's up to you to get them because I'm not going to even be here next week. So,
bye-bye, everybody. Good night.
Bye,
Alan.
Bye, Alan.
Have a nice visit.
Yep.
Sounds like Susan, can I volunteer? Is Kevin looking for an all Kevin night?
Okay, hold on a second.
Susan, can I volunteer for a category?
Should we do...
Do you want to do it?
I think Jamie wants to do it.
Try and get the volunteers.
I'll do one.
Yeah.
And okay, I got Jamie. I put Jamie on the list. Who else?
Okay, I'll do a category next week.
I have a category that I was supposed to do that I didn't when John went in the hospital.
All right, you up for doing that?
Sure.
All right, got Jamie and Janine.
As long as he doesn't do a repeat act, I can...
Hold on. Kevin, you wanted to do one?
I got a whole week's old.
Well, so you got at least one then. I'll put you down for one.
No.
No?
No.
You only have
to do the whole night. I got a whole night planned.
Give them the week.
The following week?
Yeah, like a whole week. I wrote five categories. In the future.
And there's a mystery.
I suppose I could write one more for next week if you really want me to.
Leonard? You haven't
done one. I can do one.
You're not going to be around, are you? Oh, no, you will be, huh? It's the couple weeks after that.
Yeah, it's a couple weeks. I won't be, well, actually, the week that I will be in Buffalo, I wouldn't be here anyway because it's the first Thursday and I'd be doing my monthly thing.
Mm.
Wait,
when you get all the rounds,
let me check. Hold on.
When you get everything assigned, Rob,
Karen,
I want to see the scores again once you're done with all this.
Robin, Deborah,
anyone?
Ben,
anyone?
You're very good at reading the names.
Who? What, say Karen?
Bonus.
I think
they're both open. They're both open right now.
I do a category.
All right. Very good. And so then we only need a bonus.
I'll do the bonus.
Boom.
Boom.
Ew.
Who is that? Robin? I wasn't the having this thing. Okay. Yeah.
Assuming I'm alive next week, we'll see.
Oh, no, don't say such things.
We'll be doing
Robin.
It from our hospital room.
Can I see the scores again, Rob? Because I wasn't looking at the scores.
All right, just to make sure. So I got Jamie, Janine, Leonard, Karen, and Robin with the bonus. All selected for. Okay, so go back to the share of the screen.
Okay, so you all have at least 2 weeks to watch the complete Blake 7 before.
Yeah, apparently. Blake 7, I got so many.
Wrong. I just looked at this one BritBox.
And sorry, Karen, about Walmart. Oh, we should just put it.
I did not know.
We were confused by the. We weren't sure if Walmart. We should have just picked it because that's a more well-known name. Good. On whether Walmart or because Sam's Club on what the parent company name was. We should have just went with Walmart.
But
stayed in order the whole time.
I was just guessing though, so I did not.
No, it was a great guess though.
I didn't know
it was in there.
I think we thought that Walmart may have not been a public company. Well, I think actually some people.
Well, that's the other thing that we weren't sure of too, because we were worried that it was just owned by the Waltons and not publicly traded. But right, I guess that was back in the day.
It's definitely publicly traded. I was Carl, Caspian.
So, Carl, did you get the shot?
A couple days. We'll just sit and watch Blake.
I got it.
Okay. All right. It looks like there's like a whole bunch more files here than there were categories. What's the story?
Well, a couple of them. If somebody wanted to use it, I have a question and answer separate PowerPoint.
Okay.
So that you could actually use it for your own trivia somewhere.
Rob,
like
did you give Karen said? Mike, Peggy.
Hi, Peggy.
Hi.
Rob, did you
get
that?
Yourself, Rob.
No, I don't know what you're talking about.
She's saying that she's going to arrive late probably on next week, Karen. So
okay.
In one of the later categories.
Okay.
Karen was in my backyard last night for 3 hours. So she's next week's sick person. We sat in my backyard. It was very windy and we were outdoors only. And so, I sat and did a rapid test at the beginning of our little party, which was negative. But this morning, that negative test this morning kind of had a real faint pink line.
So I have my little plan. I went to the CDC. So potential exposure happened from 7 to 9 p.m. on Wednesday, the 11th. So I am masking and I'm washing my hands and doing and staying distanced in my house from the 76-year-old I live with. Oh, and then I'm going to do a test on the 14th and I'm going to do another test on the 16th or 17th. And I'm going to look for a fever. I'm checking my oxygen levels and making sure I can smell.
Are you gargling with Clorox and injecting it?
No, please.
Karen.
I can still smell, but I have a feeling I'm going to lose it.
Karen, the new variant doesn't kill your sense of smell in most people.
Okay. Yeah. So I'm checking.
And it may not give you a fever. It's more like a sniffly cold. It's just like Robin looks. Yeah.
Sniffle. I mean, I've got like a runny nose.
Well, yeah, I'm just being away from people and protecting myself. And then I'll take the test. You're supposed to take the test in 2 to 3 days.
Hey.
I tested positive on the 8th day. I was testing every single day.
So I tested positive. I had symptoms 3 days after exposure, likely exposure. Uh-huh. I didn't test positive, even though I had symptoms for another 2 days. Uh-huh. And then for a whole week later, I kept testing positive. I was testing every other day and it was just still positive. But at that point, it was very confusing because when you're at, you say basically ignore that because you're not contagious anymore. It's very weird.
Yeah.
No, keep in mind.
It is. It's like when you're testing negative. At the time that you're most contagious,
yeah,
and then
exactly.
You're testing
Yeah, and with the new variants, you're actually very contagious even before you show symptoms.
Susan wants to interject something important.
Hello.
Oh my gosh.
Hi, Susan.
So Memorial Day weekend, probably I'm going to have a party at my house, so everybody needs to be healthy for that.
What day is that? What
I should be good by then.
Oh, you won't be here yet, Richard.
The last Monday in May.
I'll be visiting you later in, when am I visiting you? No, I'm visiting you mid-July. Yeah.
I thought it was mid-June.
Mid-July.
Hey, wait, what's your plan, Richard? Do you have multiple trips planned to the US?
No, I'm flying from Sydney to Oregon, spending a week with Brian. Then I'm flying to the Bay Area for 2 weeks or something. Then I'm spending about 3 days with Susan.
What day do you think you're going to be with me?
What day do I think I'm going to be with you?
when are you going to be in Oregon?
Well, I'm flying into Oregon. I'll be there on the 16th. I arrive into Bend.
16th of July.
Yeah, and then I'm just going to be
doing something
around Bend.
Around that time, I'm going to be looking for a speaker for our annual meeting in Portland.
Oh boy!
I'm probably.
We had fun
coming
last time. You can close us down and open us back up.
Well, there's a thought. I must say though, I'm happy to do whatever I can, but it's up to Brian because maybe we can. You can coordinate. I'm just going to be going to Bend. I'm going to be there to get over jet lag and just get my sea legs back and see that. Because I love Oregon so much. So I don't know, maybe. Anyway, Susan.
Maybe you could do the Richard and Brian show.
So Richard, when are you coming to me?
I accept payment in root beer. okay, root Susan. Beer. I hope to visit beautiful Salinas on the 8th of July.
Okay, I'm writing it down.
That's before you go to Oregon.
No, I'll be in Oregon in the 16th of June.
June?
You're going to be here for a long time.
21 days or something. Anyway, some weeks, yeah. Well, it's a long way to go for a short visit, so I'm going to make the most of out of it.
Exactly.
So at the moment I arrive into Bend on the 16th,
Well, Redmond, probably.
Redmond, yeah.
So that means if Richard's coming to my house in July, that means we're going to have another party at my house. So
sounds good.
Keep that in mind, people.
But you can't have the Memorial Day party because you're allowed a limited number of parties.
No, I'm not. I didn't have a whole
She hasn't come anywhere near her limit.
I'm nowhere near my limit. If we go on average.
Yeah, you've banked up a large surplus of available parties.
Yeah, so Memorial Day weekend. And
I'll be in Oregon until, and I leave Oregon on the 27th. But again, it really is up to Brian and Lisa because they might have a plan or something else in mind. I don't know. I'll have to leave it to them.
And are you're flying down to the Bay Area?
Yeah, so I'll be able to catch up with you, Leonard, after the 27th.
Yeah, I may actually be up in Bend around the same time as you are.
Oh, great! I'm sure we can catch up. That would be really good.
Yeah.
So I'll see if I can catch up with Greg Duray and anybody in the Bay Area. That'd be really cool. I can't tell you how much I'm looking forward to going downtown and just going back to Fisherman's Wharf and having my clam chowder.
You have no idea how great it sounds just hearing you say these things.
Yeah.
If Richard's coming from Australia to California and Oregon, then the world must be opening up.
It's starting to, it's positive. It's a good thing.
We have clam chowder and a Fisherman's Wharf in Monterey too.
He's coming here.
Yeah, I'm coming. I'm coming to Salinas.
We have it.
He's coming to
Salinas. In fact, the last time I was in Salinas, I spoke at Skepticamp, didn't I?
Yep.
Susan. Yep.
No, that was the last time.
The last time I saw you, I spoke at Skeptic Camp in Monterey.
I think you came after that.
I don't think so.
Well, you know what?
It's been a long time, Susan.
I'm not paying attention.
You remember that Skeptic Camp, don't you?
Oh yeah, of course. But
yeah, that was the last time.
That was January.
That was January 2000. 2020. Yep, that's it. Because I flew back to Australia in January 2020, then the virus really hit and started to close borders and everything.
That was our last live event.
Yeah. How about that?
Okay, I need to go because I've got a couple emails and stuff I got to deal with.
All right.
In the night. So good night, everybody.
Bye, everyone. Thank you.
Good night, everybody. Good night, Richard.
Good night.
Bye, John boy.
Leonard, how's your hip doing?
Spectacularly.
You're past all the tough stuff and
it's insane. I went for a 3-mile walk the other day, went for a 2-mile walk yesterday. It's great. I can walk better now than I have at any time in the last 8 years.
Wow.
Fabulous. Oh, wow.
That's
really awesome. I have a neighbor. I live in Canada. And of course, right now, getting any kind of surgery is like 3 years ahead. He spent $35,000